And we're back, guys. Welcome to Fresh Fit Podcast, After Hours Edition. We got a packed house. Let's get right into it. What's up, guys? Welcome to the show, man. Quick announcements before we get into it, man. We got a special guest in the house, Mr. Organik, by the way. Back.
Welcome back, brother.
Man. Definitely three of them.
Yeah, too.
Yeah, man. So real quick, guys, patreon.com/freshfit, where you guys can see all the exclusive behind-the-scenes content. And then also make sure to get and go, come to our party. God damn it, May 15th.
May 15th. It's going to be lit.
It's going to be in North Miami. We're going to put the link in the description so you guys can come. Buy your ticket there, general admission and or VIP. Come to party, meet me and Fresh, Mr. Organik, and come hang out with us, man. It's going to be a good time, our 100K celebration. Maybe we'll be at 200K by the time we get there. Who knows?
And all the girls from the show that you want to meet.
Yeah.
And we have Kiki Clout in the house.
Yes.
Kiki Clout as
What's
well.
What's up, bitches?
Yeah. Welcome back, Kiki.
Welcome back, Kiki.
Welcome back, welcome back. Also, guys, what else? Oh, yeah, we're on every single podcast platform, guys. Yep. Spotify, Apple, and Google. Go ahead and download, listen to us there. Just make sure you have headphones so you don't go get in trouble or get sent to HR.
And also, we are on Twitch now. Don't forget that, guys. Go follow us real quick. We're almost monetized and it's going to be lit. So
yeah, guys, we're trying to take over Twitch, and I can't wait for the ethots to get mad and try to get me canceled on there as well, just like TikTok for the fourth time. So with that said, man, real quick, super chats that just came in. Atif Riyadh, Team Kiki, $5. Thank you so much.
Oh, off the rip.
And then we got Kyle D'Amito, $1.99. Crypto bag going nuts. Absolutely.
Yeah, that crypto very important. Y'all better tap in.
Absolutely.
Thanks.
Ethereum or BTC, man. That's what I'm in. So
Ethereum heavy.
Exactly. Yeah, for sure. Especially now, it's skyrocketing.
Long game.
So what else? Okay. So yeah, okay. Let's introduce the people on the panel, man.
Okay, so ladies, we'll start here. Just say your name, your age, and what you do for a living.
Okay, I'm starting. I got Catherine from Mexico, and people told me it's Cardi. You can say Miss Cardi.
Miss Cardi?
It's Cardi, yeah.
Okay, and what do you do for work?
I have microblading. I have my microblading studio and my own brown
talking to the
cosmetics.
Mic. Talking to the mic.
Talking to the mic?
Hola, let's speak. I do microblading for bros, and I have my own brand of cosmetics.
Cool, and how old are you?
Mexico.
No, how old are you?
Oh, I'm 22.
All right, cool. Awesome. And you?
My name is Molly Creams. I'm 18 years old, and I have an OnlyFans.
Okay, cool. Shout out to that.
Yay.
All right.
Hey, lovies. I'm back. So,
Miss Green.
As some of you know, I'm 27, and I'm from LA. I'm on unemployment, but what I did not mention last time is that Lisa and I over here, we have a rap group called Rich Dolls, and we're going to be releasing music soon.
Yeah, hold on. No. Before you even get into that, I think you have something to say to Fresh.
I'm so sorry, Fresh, for everything.
Yeah.
For the last podcast. I was so drunk. My goodness. Before the show, I had tequila. During the show, I had champagne and vodka, and I had not ate anything that day, and I had partied all weekend. I was so hungover. Like, my goodness. I was a wreck.
Okay.
Never drinking like that again.
Yeah, because that was kind of weird. But that explains kind of like somewhat.
I was so messed up.
Somewhat what happened there.
Okay. Like, I remember some things from the interview, but I don't remember everything. And I haven't watched the interview fully. I've watched like little clips of it just because I'm embarrassed and I don't really want to watch it.
All right, well, hopefully you don't touch Mr. Organik, but we'll see.
Not happening again.
I know the fabric looks so appealing, but, you know, keep the hands to themselves.
Yes.
All right, cool.
Yo, yeah, I'm Mr. Organik, that's all. I'm just a, you know, entrepreneur, creator, just, you know what I'm saying, a different type of individual. That's it, that's all. The rest is evident in the air.
There you go.
Awesome.
All right, Kiki.
What's up? I'm Kiki Clout. Y'all already know who I am. What's up, y'all? All right, bet. I'm back in the building. I ain't got much to say because y'all know who I am. But actually, for the ones who haven't been here before, I'm Kiki Clout, 25, porn star, local to South Florida, and yeah, I'm a freak.
Nice.
Right. Some treats.
Facts. Okay.
Hey y'all, I am Alice Visby. I am new to porn 2021. I actually live in the same building as Kiki Clout, and yeah, she's the one that brought me here today. I am 24, from Virginia. That's what it is.
Welcome.
All right. Welcome.
What's going on? My name is Abril Elon. I'm a 29-year-old traveling celebrity hairstylist coming from Atlanta, Georgia.
Awesome. Good to know.
Cool. Pleasure there.
Hi, guys. I'm Lisa Monaco, and I'm 30, and I don't work because I'm from Miami, and no Miami girl works. I'm living this Miami lifestyle without a job.
Oh, shit. Hey.
Okay.
Legendary.
Are you sponsored?
Good girls never tell.
Okay.
Translation,
awesome.
Yes.
Okay. Awesome. Super chats.
Okay, and then we got Black Wolf Inc. $10. Tonight we're getting fucked up. Myron, the ladies are going to prove you right before the shower is over. Also, YouTube unsubscribed me this morning, so make sure you're sub, gentlemen. Yeah, guys, don't forget to like, subscribe, and comment below. Because it helps with the algorithm and helps us get pushed. Dylan Pereira, $2.99. Thank you so much. And then we got AdTem, $10. Paying my dues off to the Fresh Fit Fam team. Push it to the limit. Mr. Organik, you have a great personality, and I can say with certainty that it helped you in becoming who you are today. Great to see Kiki back. Thank you so much, Adam.
All praise the Most High.
Yep.
Genghis Khan, okay. Have you ever thought of linking with TJ, Manny Koshbin, or Kevin Edwards for real estate? What do you think will be your next leap of faith?
Oh, yeah, those are all legendary guys. We link, real estate-wise, me and my dog Slim, we finna start tapping into that. Mm. But we got so many equities, so many different enterprises we in already now. So we already mastering that shit. So real estate. Now, I actually got a 90 unit I'm looking at in Minnesota next week. So, yeah, it's finna happen big time, big
soon.
Yeah, nice. Yeah, we ain't playing. But shout out to all those guys, man. I like that name, Genghis Khan. That's my favorite conqueror.
Boom.
Lethal Weapon, Weapon 6. Shout out to Kiki Clout and Mr. Organik. Thank you for the hard work, Fresh and Fit. Bro, you guys don't even
organic
know.
Thank
love.
You, man.
Jamie, I can't even read because it's orange.
James Urisafi, $20, says, trying to get on your level of swag, Mr. Organik. What glasses are those?
That could never happen. Get on my level. I'm just sorry. Like, God put something in me that only I could obtain. But these glasses are Cartier. They're vintage. There was a 1932 edition. You can't get these either. Sorry.
Damn.
Oh, shit.
Yeah. Peanut patootie, £5. I'm going to say a prayer before the show starts. Bismillah al-Rahman.
Bismillah Rahman Rahim. It's Arabic. All right,
did
thank
I just
you, bro. I appreciate
it. Mashallah.
Yeah. y'all really got Chanel West Coast on here twice. Greatest podcast in the world. Thank you so much, Ronald H.
Thank you, brother.
And then from there, 10 bucks and up.
Yeah, because we're already at 2,000 live viewers, guys. I'm just going to keep climbing because I know how you guys are.
Oh, they're going to go crazy.
Because I'm showing titties.
So, yeah, first question, ladies. How important is money in your relationship of today?
Jesus.
So, we'll start here.
I'm going to be honest. I think it's...
Be honest by talking into the microphone, please.
Sorry.
Imagine it's a big black penis.
Oh, sorry.
Yeah.
It's just important. Just because.
Oh, shit.
No, but just say why it's important for you because
Because every girl likes to be treating like a princess. And for you have a princess or half, you have to can afford it. You know what I mean? So I think it's for that.
So you're saying like it's like a necessary evil because you need it?
Yes. Yes, it's like a necessity.
We good. It's one of the panels fell.
Okay.
Shit happens though.
Motherfucking
ghost. Oh my goodness.
I thought somebody fell.
Oh, nigga, what is she talking about?
I'll
put it back up.
Oh man.
Alright, go ahead, continue on.
Okay, so
we do it live.
We do it live, baby.
Money is important in a relationship because it's just a necessary thing. If the guy isn't paying the bills, then you're paying everything by half. So it's basically for survival and all that. And broke boys don't deserve no pussy. Ooh. Cardi B.
I know that's right.
I know that's right.
Wait, how old are you again?
18.
God damn, starting early, bro.
Yeah. Now that I started early, that's okay. Right at the age you learn that
they
shit.
Learn, yeah.
Look,
early
to live. Keeping it real, though. I like that. Keeping it real.
Long life to live.
Yeah, keeping it real, though.
Oh, no, she's young. No doubt about that. Yeah. But shit, that's the perfect age to learn.
She's
like,
on the right path.
On the right path.
She knows. I mean,
you're going to learn some shit you ain't supposed to be learning, though. Like, if you're thinking that money is going to do something for you, you're going to be lost in translation. Mm. You know what I'm saying? A lot of niggas be pump faking with the money. They're going to take advantage of you. You know what I mean? So you got don't let that money lead you astray.
How can you pump fake with the money though?
Oh, it's simple. Just like women pump
not
fake
unless
with
you get a deposit.
It's like they pump. Yeah, that's selling pussy. Niggas doing that, then shit, they paying for it. God bless them. But I'm talking about somebody she's looking for a relationship wise. You talking about relationship, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So you know what I mean? If you're looking at that money can confuse you sometimes. You know what I mean? Mm. So, but it's important, I guess. You know, I get what you're saying, but you'll learn over time.
All right.
So you're speaking facts.
Yeah.
So I do think money is important, but if you are not making that much money, but you have goals that will get you to make a lot of money in the future, then that's fine with me.
Okay. I remember last show you said that you're on unemployment, right?
Yes.
So would you date a guy that has like no money, so to speak?
No money? Does he not work? Because on unemployment, you do make money.
But let's say he had unemployment too. Like, would that be good for you?
Well, it depends because, I mean, I don't know how it is in the state of Florida, but in California, you make a decent amount. So, I mean, I make the maximum in California plus the supplemental amount. So, is he making... Because I do know some people also that make, like, $100 a week because they weren't making that much beforehand. So, if you're making $100 a week, then no, I'm not okay with that.
Mm-hmm.
So you need depends. To go out. Mm-hmm. You need to go out and look for a job if you're making $100 a week.
Okay. All right. Kiki?
Are we skipping him?
Oh, you want me to answer?
Yeah.
Well, okay, cool.
What you mean, like, for a woman to have money to fuck with me because I'm rich?
Well, it was for the girls.
Oh,
but,
shit. You're throwing it out there
no,
like
it's,
that.
No, it's for the girls, Kiki. Okay. It's for the girls.
Well, I was about to say, because, I don't know. About to,
it's for ladies.
The girls,
it's
I
for the ladies.
Teach, you know what I mean?
And don't worry, the ladies, you guys will be able to ask us a question, too.
Yeah.
So don't worry. You'll get your chance as well.
Kiki, go ahead.
I'm not looking for a relationship unless it's financial.
She ain't playing.
Period.
Period. Next.
Hey,
okay. As far as me, I have been on my own since I was 17. I've been hustling since then. I make hella money on my own. I don't need someone to hold me back, weigh me down. So if you can't at least match what I'm bringing to the table, you can't sit.
Mm.
That's how I feel. And then if you make more, I mean, you're welcome. But you got to make at least what I'm making. That's how I feel.
Okay. So on your level or above?
Yeah, I mean, for sure.
That's fair.
Yeah, finances are very important. It's not everything. It's not the most important. But I need at least an equal match at a bare minimum. Just at the age I'm at and where I'm going in life, I got to be at least equal match, and then from there we have to level up.
Okay. All right.
I like that. Well, I think finances are very important. I don't believe in equally being yoked and pulling my weight. I believe like the man is the provider, and in order for me to look at him with respect and as a man, you're gonna have to bring in the coins, you know. And you know, potential can only get you so far. Like, at the end of the day, like, I need to see the fruit that you are bearing. I don't give a damn about no damn tree.
Ooh.
The leaves, I don't care.
SRTF.
I don't care nothing about that. What are the fruit that you are bearing so I can know to take you serious or not, you know?
All right, so I like to keep things tangible. So we're going to go back around this way. Can you ladies give me a number? How much do they have to earn per year annual?
If I make six figures, he gonna make six figures.
Right. If I don't make six figures, he still has to make six figures and
okay.
above.
So, all right, so 100,000, bare minimum for you.
Bare.
What about you?
200.
A bare minimum. Is
six figures?
Yeah.
100.
Bare.
Kiki, bare for you. I know you don't date, but bare minimum for you?
Bare minimum? I don't know, man, because I normally don't know what they make. They just put in my pocket. I don't know.
Okay, well, what kind of money are they putting in your pocket then? And then we can get an estimate from there.
Two, three, five, 10 bands.
And at a time, right?
Yeah, okay. Definitely. 15 bands. You already know. Like, okay. Yo, I can collect.
On how much? How frequently?
Oh, shit, nigga. God damn.
How frequently?
I got multiple, so, I mean, it's an everyday occurrence.
I'm saying per guy, because I'm trying to figure out what the number is for you. It looks like it's going to have to be six figures bare minimum for you, too.
Yeah, that would have
with that
like
kind of money.
Of course.
Yeah.
They're giving it up like that.
All right. What about you?
So if they're already, you know, like I said, if they've already reached, if they have a career already, I'd say like 250.
Okay. $250,000. Mm-hmm. Okay. You?
Stiff.
A luxurious amount.
Oh,
I like that.
There we go.
Wait. What does that mean?
A luxurious amount. Like a good amount. Well, $100,000 a month.
A month? $1.2 million.
Okay, that's probably impossible for $100,000 a month.
No.
This question is a little bit confusing for me.
It's not impossible.
That's baby money.
Right there.
Yeah, that's easy. All right. We do that in t-shirts.
But for like a regular guy, I wouldn't look for a relationship because me, I'm focused on making my money. I'm not looking for a guy to give me money or anything. I'm trying to get it myself. But if I were to have a relationship with a guy, he'll need to be close to... Damn, it got really quiet. I don't know.
It's all right. This is six
a lot of money.
Six a lot figures. Of money. Six,
yeah,
six figures.
So,
I'm happy with five figures. I don't ask for too much.
Oh, that's what's up.
Hold on, man. You gotta stop contradicting yourself, man. So give us a number. Do they gotta make $100,000 a year? Do we gotta make $100,000 a month?
$100,000 a year.
$100,000 a year.
Or $200,000 a year, yeah.
Okay.
Okay. Between $100,000 to $200,000. Okay, what about for you?
Same thing. Shoot.
Can you please talk into the mic?
Yeah.
Same thing hair.
So same thing, $100,000?
I'm just going to skip it because she's right. So.
Wait, y'all saying a year? Y'all saying a year?
Yeah, a year.
That's nothing.
That ain't nothing, especially living in California.
Yo, that's pennies.
I live in Malibu, baby.
That's what I'm saying, a year.
I mean, but that's if you really love the person and you're really in a relationship. Nope. Like, if it's a sugar daddy, he has to be making
a million. He better bring that guac to the table.
Have more than that.
You feel me? No. Nope.
Because he can't go last. He only got $100,000
exactly.
Paying for that pussy like that.
So very interesting.
They gotta make that a week.
I have a small one fell. So question, ladies. So you guys obviously, you guys all asked for a guy. $100,000 a year puts someone automatically in the top 10% of U.S. earners.
Mm-hmm.
And that's all, men and women, mm-hmm. right?
Yeah.
So my question is this, and we'll go back around this way. What do you guys bring to the table to demand that kind of money?
And let me add one caveat.
That's the good.
You cannot include sex.
Yeah,
so there's no WAP involved.
You go to Brazil,
that's
get pussy for a handful of goddamn coffee beans.
Yeah.
Bad bitch, too.
What about good head?
How about
a
one
good
word?
Worthless.
No
one,
sexual
yeah,
energy.
Yeah, that's worthless.
So
one word?
What do you mean,
royalty.
Table?
Now you don't
know. Versus no sex. So we'll start here.
I think it's nothing more important than time. And I mean quality time and attention.
Talk into the mic, please.
Attention, you know?
So you give time and attention?
Yes. Time and attention.
Okay.
That includes everything.
And that's going to pay. Then you got to have $100,000 for your time and your attention.
Fair enough.
Yeah,
what about you?
I bring Niagara Falls to the table.
Oh, shit. She's a squirter.
We mentioned earlier.
And I bring my bank, too. I'm not a gold digger or nothing like that.
So you bring your own money.
Your own buddy, too. That counts.
Okay. You bring
so,
your own.
So do you make $100,000 a year?
I plead the fifth.
Okay.
Oh, shit.
Okay. So that's a no.
Hell no.
Bring your bank to the table. Okay.
Okay, Susie, what do you bring to the table?
I'm pretty hardworking and loyal.
Okay. Okay.
Nope. Yes, Susie.
Okay.
All right. Kiki?
My presence.
Is a present.
My presence.
Is a present. Yeah, I hear that.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. I like that.
You're welcome.
Okay, Kiki. I don't know. I would say loyalty, man. Holding each other down.
Mm-hmm.
Like, same way they do us, we do them. That's how I handle it, you know, in every aspect.
So you wouldn't cheat?
No. Damn. Okay. I haven't cheated since high school, and that was before I ever fell in love. Since then, no. Ain't worth it.
Okay.
I feel like I bring a lot to the table, a lot, outside of like the sex and all that. I'm very educated, so I'm very, very supportive, very loyal.
Mm-hmm.
I have a lot of different traits about myself that everybody wants. So, yeah, I bring a lot to the table. And I the money part as well, but I don't feel like that's the highest part because you guys know how to take care of yourself. That's just life.
Yeah, right.
So that's not like a bonus. That's just what it is.
Okay.
Well, I think I bring feminine inspiration to the table. Like Kelly Rowland say, I'm going to be your motivation. When you come home, I'm going to be in lingerie. I'm going to keep it nice and fresh and waxed for you. I'm going to cook your food.
Oh,
you just
got
to bring home the bacon. That's it.
Shit.
I don't ask for a lot.
Okay.
I mean, okay, hold on.
See, I got CEO, yeah. I got you, right?
God damn.
Hold on.
Interested, yeah, of course.
Hold on.
That's crazy.
It ain't so, regular, that's what men want, though.
I
want
to know, right?
Who want that?
So,
Chris.
Mr. Organik is a high-value guy, right?
Right.
I want to know from your brother, what do you look for in a woman? So you heard all these answers, right? What do you look for?
I mean, yeah, like, of course, most of them is going to stand on they pretty. They going to fuck you and all that. Come home. I don't give a fuck about none of that shit, man. Like, we get that dime a dozen. Like, a nigga got bread, nigga. I'm 6'6", 230. I'm smooth. Even without the money, I had every woman I ever wanted. So, like, just because you're going to be at my home when I come there cooking, I don't need that shit. You know what I'm saying? I never needed it. You know what I'm saying? I need a girl that's going to understand what I go through, who's going to keep a motherfucker on top of his toes, that's going to push him and motivate him. You know what I mean? That's also going to come with some ideas. You know what I mean? Give me creative criticism on my grind. You know what I mean? Also add to the table. You know what I mean? Not just trying to grab some food every time it's filled up. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
You got to bring something to this table. Like, fucking pussy is over with after a certain time. Like, I could fuck any bitch I ever wanted in my life. I always have. That's not appealing to me no more. You know what I mean? Once you get money and once you was already having that, you got to bring more. Your energy got to be right. Your mind got to be right. That body don't mean nothing after a while. You know what I'm saying? A nigga will fuck anything, man. So, like, you could be the baddest bitch in the world. That's fine. Nigga gonna have you, and I'm gonna fuck a bitch, motherfucker, a 2 and a 3. A nigga will do that.
Yeah.
Happens all the time. You know what I'm saying? Jay-Z had Beyonce, he still fucked some other pussy. How can you beat that? Because he would just want some new pussy on his cock. So that ain't nothing, man. It's your energy, it's your mind, what you bringing to help me grow. That was gonna help us grow. That what counts.
Yeah, preach, brother. Yeah. Preach. Yeah.
But absolutely. A bad bitch brings inspiration
not to no real nigga that already had that. If you got a fat, lame, rich nigga that need all that, I just want a bad bitch, that nigga, he's a square. Mm-hmm. He's a nobody.
Yeah.
But a nigga that been sufficient his whole life and got every girl he wanted, what is a bad bitch doing for me? That's nothing. We always had that. What you bringing more than just being a bitch? It's a million bad bitches walking this earth. That's the cheapest and most easiest thing to get for a nigga got some money is a bitch and some pussy.
Bam.
You go to, like I said, you go to Brazil right now, it's gonna be a 10,000 bad bitches you've seen in your life. You give them bitches $1 and a coffee, and that bitch gonna lick your feet, man. That's worthless to a real nigga, man.
Right.
You gotta be a fat, slow brain, regular ass nigga that finally got some money to be imposed, and I got a bad bitch. Like, come on, man. Like, that's a different type of breed of human that get they rocks off to that. You know what I'm saying? And I get it. Y'all get your money now. Go get all them niggas. But a nigga like me, that shit is, like, it's nothing. You know what I mean? Our energies got to be connected. You know what I'm saying? We got to grow together. That's the most important
thing. So you'll take a basic bitch that is somebody that you want to talk to over a bad bitch that will inspire you.
So you consider yourself a bad bitch?
No. Yeah, I do, actually.
So you above basic. Well, you don't even work. You don't have no attributes. To the table here, like what
I
are we
do
talking
have attributes. I inspire my men.
How? You don't got no job. You got what's your education?
Listen,
what's your master's
but you
degree
have
in?
To no, but you have to realize that when men make it to a certain level,
right.
They're not checking for a woman's education.
They're not.
When you're making millions of dollars, you don't care about a woman's education.
Yes, you do.
Talk to plenty of rich men.
I do. I'm a rich man. I got an estate in Malibu. Okay,
an
2 acres. Yes.
Oh,
two
I would
acres.
Like to see the paperwork.
Okay, we can show you paperwork.
Go ahead and show me the title.
We gotta show a paperwork to somebody that got no paper. That would make no sense.
Show me, pull up that deed.
Some paperwork.
Can he pull up the deed?
Can you pull up
your
car?
You don't even know what a deed is. You don't even know what a deed is because
what deed you got? What deed you got?
D to these.
You, come on, man. You got a little residue underneath your nose,
man,
baby.
He's certified.
But I get what you're saying, though.
She
fucking with loser, fat, old niggas got money. I get it.
Nah, don't negative. But when you're, seriously,
there's
when
no
you
way
reach
you got
a certain
nobody
level,
efficient
when
around
you reach
you.
A certain level, you don't care if that girl works as a bottle girl. You don't care if this
it
girl has
matter.
A job.
We
like,
didn't
you
say
don't
that.
Care.
We gotta have somebody got some smarts, though.
Because you already
tell you ain't got no smarts.
You've already made it to a certain level.
It ain't about just want to suck my dick all the time.
The energy needs to be matched.
We need, yeah.
What you're saying.
Yeah, it's bigger than
but
just.
But you're saying because she doesn't have a job or work, it don't matter. She can't match your energy?
It don't matter. I'm talking about you personally on the
educational
terms.
But you don't know
terms.
Me personally.
I could tell you ain't got no brain.
Honey, I worked in corporate finance.
You
what
did?
Are you talking?
So
yes,
why are you not
baby?
Employed now?
Because I don't want to be.
So you want to be a slave to a man with some money?
I want to, no, honey. I want to be an inspiration with someone with some money.
What, how are you going to inspire him? Please explain that.
Baby, I just told you. Obviously, you weren't listening.
I'm listening quite fine. You see you coming in lingerie, but
no, you wasn't listening,
ain't gonna,
though.
Ain't gonna
like,
do nothing for
you
a
wasn't
nigga.
Listening.
Okay, I got you. I want to listen to you.
This is awesome. Yo, okay, so let me read these super chats real quick. So, okay, these are the Queen Nidus. King Chris $10, number one podcast in the game on the come up. Thanks for coming on Mr. Organik. The seeds of growth must be sown. Thank
they
you very much.
Sown. They must be sown.
And
the
then
deeds
DeAndre
must
Miller
be shown.
$10. just caught that. Hard for me to believe that I'm a lot more realistic than a lot of the older women, 10 to 20 years older than me. God help America. Well, you know, it is what it is. David K, $20. For Velcro on the roof, Mr. Organik, keeping it real. Thank you very much. I appreciate that. Much love. We about to yell at our maintenance guy. Don't worry. Ozzy Giller, guitar man, $10. Wait, did the exorcism work? She seems sane.
She was drunk. She was drunk.
Yeah, that's all. Look, like, she
it worked,
she apologized.
Baby.
And minus $10. People like the unemployment chick is exactly why they want to cut it. She's not very bright to be talking about it like that. Ladies, have a rebuttal to that?
What do you got to say?
How am I not very bright? What do you mean? Just because of last time I said I was very drunk.
Okay, she said fuck you. All right, Schoolcraft, E313, $20. Hey, Mr. Organik, I appreciate the game given the other day. The Motor City rocking with you for show. Fresh and fit.
I love
right
Detroit,
now
man. Shout out to Detroit, man.
Shout
I appreciate
Detroit,
you.
Man. Pay roll.
Real niggas out there get money.
Frank Hayden, $20. Fresh went from I don't like black women to a whole different energy when the lighter skinned girls came around.
Nigga, I never said that. My mom is black, bro.
DeAndre Miller, $10. What advice would the ladies give to younger women who don't know what they want in life or any proper role models to follow? And then what advice would you guys give? I just want to see the difference. DeAndre, I don't know if we'll get there, but we'll see. Bilal Shabar, $20. The worldly life is nothing but an illusionary enjoyment. Quran, thank you very much. And then Young Il Thomas. And guys, from this point, we're going to go 20 and up because we're already almost at 5,000 live viewers. Thank you guys for all the donations. CD Digga Give. Okay, why should an next to fit accent fluctuating? Yeah,
wait,
do you have an explanation for that?
What's your background?
Me?
Yeah.
I'm Dominican and black.
Okay.
That's black.
You speak Spanish?
No.
Black on black.
Que triste.
Black on black.
Yeah, okay. Dominicans ain't nothing but niggas with straight hair. Shout out to them, though.
Self-aspired, $50. These girls will reject 65K men now, but when they turn 35, they will still be single, and they will be shopping in the discount aisle for 25K men, calling up Kevin Samuels.
Yeah, oh, shit.
Queen Ida, $20. These are the kind of horticulture implements that want an equal match but won't know how to make you a BLT. Oh, a BLT sandwich. Okay, trophies. The kind you can't have. Sorry, the kind you can't have in an intelligent conversation because they're the lowest common denominator. Damn, and that's a woman that said that. Damn, okay.
She's ugly.
Yeah. Oh, shoot, back. They said you ugly, queen. Queen Nidus, they said you ugly.
Give Cole $20. So here we have an experienced multimillionaire dropping gems, and rather than peep game, these young ones with less experience just won't listen.
Ooh. Okay.
Son of Batman, $20. It ceases to amaze me that women really struggle to find qualities beyond sex and looks to add to a man's life. That's a low-value woman's mindset, but they want men that are out of their league for LTR.
Yeah. Now, I will say this to Ms. DR's point. I get it, because, like, yes, there are guys out there that make a lot of money that don't care about a woman's career, which I agree with. That's true. But what I will say is this. When you're dealing with guys that, like, have options with women, you have to bring more to the table. I will say that. Like, you know, just being pretty in itself, that'll work for a guy that, like, you know, he worked his ass off, became a millionaire, whatever it is. Right. Maybe he's a fat loser, struggle women. Yeah. That'll work for him.
Yeah.
But, like, if you want to deal with, like, dudes that, like, that have money and have options, then you're going to have to bring more to the table than just sex. You might be able to get them if you're bad enough, but are you going to be able to keep them?
Yeah,
look, he will smash you for a while.
For sure.
But then the one that adds value, he's gonna make her number one
for sure.
So and she'll be uglier than you too. Yeah, that's the funny part. Yeah, and that's why so many women get mad. They'll be like, "Oh, he's with this basic bitch. What the fuck?" Yeah. But the thing is that basic bitch does a lot of things behind the scenes that are complex. Yeah. She might look basic, but she does complex things.
And he is dogging that basic bitch out.
How so?
Oh,
believe me. Oh, you mean by having sex with other girls?
Oh, yeah.
No, that's nothing. That's not cheating, though.
Nah, he's dogging her out. The basic bitch ain't getting no trips. She ain't getting no shopping sprees. She not getting no Birkins. She's not doing, I promise you, she's living in hell. And unfortunately, mm-hmm. I feel bad, but that's the reality.
If that's his woman, guaranteed they're getting all that too.
They are
too. No. Okay. But she's living in emotional turmoil.
Nah,
okay.
Nah,
but oh, yes. I don't think
so. Obviously, right? You have a lot of experience. So I'm curious. let's go on the panel, right? Tell me about a guy you dated, a high value guy, ooh, how you got him. Right? So a guy, maybe a millionaire, like, tell me how you bagged the guy and have money.
How did I bag him?
Yeah.
I mean, literally, like, I could just be walking in, like, some, like, tight clothes or something like that. They'll stop the car. They'll be like, hey, how are you? I could meet him in the
how
club.
How much for that motherfucker right now? Give me some head. I got $10 in my pocket. I know you. I know
oh,
something
honey,
worth.
No. Oh, my bad. I wouldn't even talk to you.
Not for $10?
I wouldn't even look at you. If you got $10, what are you writing
in? Yeah, that's
in?
Disrespectful, huh?
You
yeah.
in a hoopty.
That's true. That's true. $20. No, it's fine. Go ahead. Finish your point. My bad.
So I don't even know where I was going.
So basically, you just
he was asking,
life.
How would you attract a higher status guy?
Yeah. Oh, how would I attract? Yeah, just, I mean, literally, like, you'd never go to them. You let them come to you. Mm-hmm. You know, that's the key.
Okay.
You know, because if they want you, they're going to come to you. And they do, believe it or not. Like, they really do. And then after that, you just talk to them. You let them know your value as a woman, as a feminine woman. Mm. We have lost the art of femininity in this culture.
That's very true.
Not in this culture. I would say, God, what is the word?
I get what you're saying, because most women are very masculine. And if you're feminine, it's like, damn, this chick's actually like some
exactly.
type of like.
Men love the feminine energy. So if you're a masculine man and you're making a lot of money, you need that balance. You need the yin to your yang. And I'm going to be your yin. Your gang.
Yeah, she knows ooh, what she's doing. Hey, she man. Next. Okay.
I'm really good with conversation. Mm-hmm. So my conversation is always going to draw in whomever. Doesn't matter the where I'm at, the location. And it also doesn't matter how I look. I could have on a fully clothed outfit. I can be at the grocery store or at the gym. It just doesn't matter. Good conversation is, it'll take me far.
So when you go about your day, and guys holler at you, you just conversate with them? Like, just do a conversation?
If I have the time to converse with them, and also if I'm in the mood.
Okay. Are you single, by the way?
I am single.
Are you single, too?
I got options.
Options?
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm single all the way.
You know she's single. That girl never know who's single.
All right, I'm going to come back to you. I'm gonna come back to y'all. Okay, for you.
What was the question?
So let's say, right, you want to lock down like a high-value guy, a guy that has money,
oh,
whatever.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
How would you go about locking down that guy?
I'm not, like, hating on anything anyone says, but, like, I don't care enough to premeditate it.
Mm-hmm.
For me, it's one thing, connection. We connect, you happen to have money, dope. Like, if you don't, no. We'll figure it out. Like I said earlier, you gotta meet what I'm bringing to the table. However, though, like, it's not, like, my main mindset, to be honest.
You're getting your bag, you're doing your own thing, so you don't really...
Yeah, but, like, for me, it's not about what I do or what I don't do or what to do. It's... Do we vibe? Do we connect? You know what I mean? Like, because I've dated people with hella money that I was like, I couldn't fucking stand you.
Right. Mm-hmm.
Sexy ass people, fucking annoying. Yeah. But then you have whack ass looking people, and then you have the best conversations of your mm-hmm. life. I mean, it's just connection at the end of the day. So
that's
what helped me meet the people that I've met.
Gotcha. Kiki.
What was the question?
Right?
Okay, okay. You're a little bit different because I know you don't want to know anybody. Yeah. So, question for you then. How do you choose which guy to go in out of all your options?
How do I choose which guy what?
To go with out of all your options.
Unless out of all my options?
Let's say you got like 20 DMs. How do you choose which guy to go with out of those DMs?
I have my manager filter through them and see which one wants to buy customs, spend time with me, basically like that, and then go from there. When I know they're serious, then I get that cash app.
Their deposit.
Man, so you got a guy helping you get guys filtering for you. That's gangsta shit. Yeah. Holy smokes.
She ain't playing no games. She about her business. You got to respect somebody that's on their business like that. Like, yeah. That's her occupation. She ain't in the mood to be, she ain't on some relationship shit. She about her bread. Like, you know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm. That's always been like
that. She might always get in that same realm. Like, that might be better for you, baby. Like, you know what I'm saying? I'm trying to tell you. You better take some pointers from her.
There you go.
Just get to the bag.
It's always been like that for me ever since I was 18, because I grew up in that shit. I ran away from home when I was 17, so I never, like, I had to come up from nothing. No shoes, no, I had a shirt, a pair of shorts, no phone, no wallet, no nothing. Went to high school, got my diploma, went to college a little bit, but you know, at the end of the day, like, I learned how to hustle, and you know, money is my main priority. Like, that shit pays my bills, keeps a roof over my head, keeps me fed, keeps my phone bill paid, keeps me going. So I'm not looking for nobody to settle the fuck down. I mean, you got to be Jeff Bezos type shit for me to settle down, because it's going to be a long while. I take care of my family. I ain't got time to bullshit with nobody.
Mm-hmm. Organik.
What's up, champ?
For you, brother, what would make you settle down with a girl?
I mean, like, it all settled down. Like, it depends on what we're talking about. You know what I'm saying? Like, currently, I got a female. You know what I'm saying? But at the same time, I live a free man life. I do what I want at all times. You know what I'm saying? I always live that way. Before money, I'm going to do it after the money. You know what I mean? That's the life I always wanted, and that's the life I'm going to live, point blank, period. And so for me to settle down, I don't know, it got to be God. God got to tell me to chill out. God got to tell me just to stay in the house. You know what I mean? So end of the day, whatever I want to do, I'm going to do it. You know what I'm saying? Physically, mentally, and monetarily.
You're going to be a man.
You're fucking right. And, and then I'm truthful with it. It's no lies. I don't lie, I don't cheat, I don't hide. Everything's, that's why I'm organik, because it's all natural and all real at all times. You could take it or leave it, you know what I mean? And I won't be mad about it, you know? That's just how I live my life. So when that time comes, it will come. But in the meantime, I'm living my life in its purest form.
So you would let her know up front what it really is.
You have to. How you gonna be a real nigga and all this shit you claim to be, and you gotta hide from a woman in your house? You gotta tell her lies. You gotta have 4-5 phones.
You might as well be single.
That's lame as fuck. You know what I'm saying? Like, all these niggas doing that shit to me, I told myself I'm never gonna do that. I told myself I'm never gonna be one of these niggas. I'm in love with my woman. Then they get caught cheating and all that, hiding, drunk, you doing threesomes and shit. Nah, I'm living my life in its pure form. I do what I want. You either with it and you ain't. If you're not, I understand. But in the day, I live my life for me first. Everything else is secondary. So, and that's how I'm going to live until I don't want to do it no more.
Bam.
Straight up.
Susie?
So it just depends, because every guy is different. So some guys like to have stimulating conversations. Some guys don't like to talk. So it just depends, you know. After a long day of work, they might just want to relax and maybe go to the movie theater, have a dinner. They're all so different, so it just depends.
I'm curious. Have you dated any, like, celebrities before?
Can't say anything.
Okay, how did you get them then, you would say?
I mean, I just met them when I was out, and they approached me. They thought I was cute. They sent over their entourage, and
that was it?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Girls live life on easy mode.
Easy mode.
Face down, ass up.
You know what I'm saying? Okay.
Okay.
I believe in the universe. The universe loves me, and the universe is going to give me what I want.
Oh, God.
Manifestation.
Okay. Excellent. It's just hope.
So I smile. Uh-huh. I smile. I sprinkle the personality in it, and then it is what it is.
And then boom.
Bam. It just happened.
Kabow.
All right.
Okay.
Mexico.
The fucking same. I'm Mexican, and in my country, your mom always say to you, like, if you want, you only have to talk with the universe and God is going to bring you. You know what I mean?
All right.
It's like, connection is important. And not every guy is, like, interesting. Some guys I'm boring. Mm-hmm. And this is not, like, you know, I don't know how I can explain, but I mean, they always come to me and it's like magic.
It works out.
Yes.
All right. Cool.
Yes, yes.
Snap of the finger.
So, ladies, we're going to let you guys ask the question next. I'm going to read these super chats, and then we'll go this way. So, All right, cool. So Ms. Mexico, I have something ready to go. Okay, so Blake Williams, $50. Organik spend, straight facts. Yep,
organik,
absolutely.
Always.
And we got I is for the Luden, $20. Love the Fresh Fit podcast. I'm 18 and getting flown out to California for work. Money Mondays and Prada Law are really helpful. Would love to meet you guys one day. All right, thank you.
Thank you, man.
We got Black Wolf Inc. $20. The only person that has the right to a six-figure dude is Kiki Clout. She at least has celebrity in some ways and VIP in many ways. The rest of y'all are unemployed with overrated ideals.
Stop the cap.
Oh,
Stop the cap.
All right, David N. $20. Chick next to Myron is another example of women losing the plot. She argued that men value her brain, yet her current jobless existence is supported by men due to her body and looks. Yin-yang these nuts. You have a rebuttal? You have a rebuttal for that?
Hey, I do have a rebuttal.
Yeah, what is it?
You know, listen.
Okay.
Lingerie.
Hold on. Yeah, exactly.
Lingerie.
There you go.
Red panties.
The red panties.
Okay, good comeback. All
right. What?
Neo Hikari, $20. Kiki, I bet I could touch your belly button from the inside.
Oh, yeah. Send me that. Send me a picture. No, yeah, I want to see a picture. Send me a picture on Twitter.
Four by four, goddamn ass.
We'll turn it over to the ladies to ask us something.
So one question to the guys on the panel. Anything you want to know about dating, sex, whatever?
Can you repeat me, please?
Okay, so one question, right, for the guys on the panel. Let's say, okay, why do guys cheat?
We might need the girl to the right to help her out.
Yeah.
I ain't gonna lie. Okay. Yeah, she's gonna have to translate.
Can I say it again?
So one question for the ladies, right? You can ask anything regarding dating, lifestyle, sex.
This is for all our Telemundo viewers right now.
What do you want to know about guys, basically?
Le puedes hacer cualquier pregunta a los chicos de sexo, de si pegan tarro.
Sí, claro, sí.
Sí, pegatarro.
¿Pero a quiénes? ¿A los que nos están viendo?
No, to the people watching or to the guys?
To us.
Oh, no, to us.
Yeah.
To
a los que están
yeah,
viendo
to us,
aquí.
Yeah.
Okay. Like...
Just ask it in Spanish. Ask it in Spanish and let her translate.
No, solo quiero...
This is all for all our Hispanic viewers right now. I know you guys love this.
Yeah, they do.
Que paso, que me dejen a lo último y que cuando todos contesten, ya me doy una idea, ya puedo poder contestar.
She said that she wants to be the last person I answer to hear what the other girls
are. Okay, so you made us translate all that.
Oh, shit.
Fucking...
Okay,
go ahead.
Okay, so what I would ask the guys on the table, do you guys keep it real with your woman all the time, at all times, every second of the day?
That's if I had a woman. But just cricket. For your example, if I'm dealing with a chick, I'm gonna let her know up front what it really is. Because to me, like, lying and hiding behind text and like trying to hide shit, like, that, you're not a man, you're a coward. Because if you were real to yourself and that's what you do, why are you gonna lie to her? But most guys, they want to keep the box, they want to lie to girls and kind of, you know, play behind the scenes because they don't want to let the girl know what it really is. But a real nigga is gonna tell you, you know what, this is what I do, this is what I'm about, take it or leave it. If you don't like it, then...
Okay, cool. So for the guys that don't tell their woman straight up to their face, like, what it is or what it ain't, like, if you want to be in a relationship with me, I'm going to tell you straight up, I'm not going to be loyal. Do you think that they're two-faced in a way?
I wouldn't say they're two-faced. It's just they gotta have an understanding. And then you got to know the caliber individual you're dealing with. You know, it's just reality. Like, if a nigga... Like I said, a person that been getting girls his whole life, be cool, and he got money. This nigga ain't working out. This nigga ain't wearing all this jewelry, having all these cars to come home to one woman. It just ain't going that way. You got to look at that motherfucker you're fucking with like, you think this nigga just come home to you only? It's impossible. So if he's, and it's even rare for a nigga to be sturdy enough to be like, hey, listen up, let me tell you the truth. Like, you ain't never got to worry about nothing. I love you. We're going to be together forever. Ain't nothing you ever going to, your family, nobody has to worry about nothing. But every now and then something might come up, just know that, you know what I mean? I ain't treating her like you, but that guy got to be sturdy enough to know, like, I ain't taking her on no trips. I ain't buying her shit. I ain't doing all that shit either. You know what's going on. You know what I'm saying? So only nigga that got to do all those trips and buying all those bags because they doing it behind their girl back so they don't get told on. So who the fuck want to live like that? You know what I'm saying? I'm not saying I'm doing it. I'm just saying, for instance, if I was in that situation, it's going to be some understanding. And you going to know what's going on. I don't want you out the loop because I care for you.
Right.
So I'm not going to have you looking stupid. You know what I'm saying? I don't want to break your heart because you're going to sign up for this. We sign up together. this is a joint thing here. We in this motherfucking together. I'm a nigga. I'm a barbarian. I'm gonna knock some shit down. But goddamn, baby, don't worry about it. You know what's going on. Mm. I ain't gonna sit here and tell you, hey, baby, I have to go out fuck a bitch tonight. You know what I'm saying? But every now and then I'm on a trip or something. Hey, somebody tell you, oh, I was with your boyfriend. Just be like, hi. God bless you.
Whatever,
you
know what happens, saying? Happens.
Yeah, yeah. And then they text your girl like, oh, I'm gonna tell your girl. Go tell her. You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So just be truthful. I don't think it's too fast. I think it's one of the purest things you ever do. It's got to be, you got to be a top level, you know what I'm saying, like a real, just a sturdy individual to do that with a woman. You know what I'm saying? Because everybody can't do that. And I can't even get mad at niggas that don't do it because it's a 1% of the 1% that can do that.
One of the ones. What
I'm saying? And that's why I'm Mr. Organik. I'm one of the ones. I'm not like no other. Straight up.
So, real quick, we just got a big 200 super chat.
But TV,
that's heavy.
TV. God
damn,
thank
TV.
You so much for that, bro.
TV, I can't do with that big motherfucker.
So here we go. Fresh Fit, bringing it real. You boys doing the Lord's work, changing my life. Appreciate it. One of these days, I will get out to Miami. Drinks are on me. Cheers. Thank you so much, TB. I appreciate
that. Thank you, TB. $200.
That money will go towards putting up more sound panels on the ceiling.
You need that, man.
That won't fall.
More super chats, man.
There you go. Thank you guys so much for the support. But does that answer your question?
I have my own opinions.
What's your opinion?
What's your opinion then?
My opinion is that the guys that can't tell their woman straight up to their face that they're going to be doing other things on the side, like, it's really respectful of you to tell me that and not to rub it in my face saying that, oh, I'm going
to
go there.
Stupid. Yeah, don't
yeah
want you to
always
stupid.
Put the respect there.
Always.
So that's very important, but I still
but
feel
the guys
like
that don't tell you, you don't like that, right?
I don't like that. You're two-faced. What are you? What are your true intentions? What's going on?
Yeah, that's a difficult thing to do.
Yeah.
But you gotta understand that most guys, like, they want you, but they don't want to, how to put this? They don't want to lose you.
Right.
So the fact that they may lose you by saying the truth, they don't want to lose you, so they're not going
to
say it.
Yeah, the truth is, like, the hardest thing to tell a woman to tell you the truth. Like, they be like, tell me this, and you be like, okay. Like, they be like, okay, I'm going to come over tonight. You know what I mean? You don't want no sex, do you? You know goddamn well you want that goddamn sex, but you can't be like, yeah, I want to fuck that pussy, come over.
Yeah.
She ain't going to come. But if you don't say, no, nah, baby, come watch a little goddamn Netflix and I got some Ritz crackers and shit, they're going to come over, you're going to fuck anyway.
Yep.
So you just can't be truthful all the time on certain things. You just can't. It's just how the world works. A woman don't want to hear that shit, even they ask you, beg you. No, it's not just sex, son. Of course it's not. You know goddamn well it is. You just can't tell them. They know, you know. But don't be dumb enough to tell them, because you ain't going to get that pussy, brother. Bam. Just say no.
At the end of the day, they're not bad guys. They're greedy.
They are greedy.
It's not bad. They're just greedy.
That's a fact.
And here's the other thing, too. Women, you guys don't operate in reality anyway, so we can't tell you guys the truth regardless. You know what I mean? If I'm going to be honest.
Yeah.
You
right.
Know? Like, you, women go off of emotions, how they feel. You guys don't operate. Men live in a fact-based reality. You guys live in a bizarre world. And I know that sounds very sexist and asshole-ish or whatever, but it's true.
Yeah.
A fat man that's a loser, society reminds him that he's a loser and fat and not going to get girls, whatever it is. Men are punished for not performing. Women aren't.
Yeah.
No diss to the women at the table here. But we got two ladies here that are unemployment that are rubbing elbows with celebrities and making and doing their thing.
You're right.
You just wait and approach, you know?
You know
just
what I'm saying?
There,
like,
you know?
Like you
around.
Got you really think if I was unemployed, I'd be able to meet a celebrity or date a celebrity or have access to any type of like high value woman, attractive girl?
Sheesh.
Come you
know,
on.
There's girls that are bums that get invited to hang out with Future. Yeah. You know, oh, you want to come hang out at the studio, whatever it is, even though he's only trying to smash. No matter, you're meeting him, his manager, you're getting certain opportunities that men are never. You think Rihanna's ever going to tell me, hey, you want to come to my fucking trailer? And I'm here in Miami
fresh.
Doing a show. Yeah. You want to come through and hang out?
Shout to Rihanna.
Hell no.
Yeah, shout to Rihanna.
Rihanna built up your confidence.
Barbados 246.
Rihanna wouldn't even give me a fucking umbrella if it was raining. Pun intended. You know what I'm saying? So the thing is this.
Oh, wait.
When I say women live life on easy mode, I don't say that to be a sexist or a jerk. It's just I accept reality that when it comes to mate selection and dealing with the opposite gender, you guys have a crazy advantage, which goes back to what I was going to say earlier. Since you guys have all these opportunities and you guys can fuck whoever you want and you have access to a whole bunch of men without really having to bring much to the table and you get access to them, there's no way that you could put the same rules on me that you put on you. Women want a guy that's loyal and not going to have sex with other girls. I'll tell you guys this right now. If a guy busts his ass to become successful like Mr. Organik, there's no way he's going to only fuck one girl, because we have to get to a certain point to be able to get that option. You guys are born with that option. We have to earn it.
Shit, we can share.
Yeah, women are really overprivileged.
We can share.
So,
we could get it so easily that a guy has to build it up from zero and like bust his ass, sweat, and all that.
So, and that's not a knock on the I didn't say that as an example to try to shame the women at the table. But what I'm saying is that if I was unemployed, I would never be able to live the life that you guys live as women.
No.
You know what I'm saying?
And only how if you can. It's like, because when I was broke, I was fucking top level women. You know what I'm saying? Because I know how to play the part. Because even when I was broke, I'm looking like an athlete. You know what I'm saying? I still know how to dress. I still look good. I'm still in shape. So I could get them a little bit, but can I keep them? No.
Yeah.
I'm going to slay that motherfucking 11-incher, you know what I'm saying, a couple months. That shit going to run out, brother.
Yeah, facts.
She going to be like, what you got? You know what I'm saying? You got to go. You can fuck the pussy. Even you turn to a woman, like, you can fuck them a couple times, but after a while, it's like, hold on, nigga, what you really got going on? Yeah. Like, you a broke nigga. Get out of here.
So,
you just like with the women, like, you can fuck a nigga a few times, but you can't keep them.
Yep.
Same
exactly.
way.
Should we just real quick? CJ Mosey, $20, says, I disagree with Mr. Organik. Chick next to Myron is worth at least $40. Also, the chick to the right of Organik looks like she's been being held hostage. Blink twice, bitch.
$40 is a good number, though. That's a good number.
You, Miss Kelly, stop staring at the TV screen, please.
Okay. Survival bias. Ron Swanson, survival bias. Logical error made my focusing on people that made it past a selection process, overlooking those who did not. This bias commonly leads to overly optimistic beliefs about reality because failures are what?
Ignored.
Nigga, speak English. Ron Swanson. Stephen Gibby 96, how much for a donation? Thank you to roast my for you to roast my IG profile.
You know what?
Bro, get on Patreon, bro.
No, you know what? Send 200. Yeah. We'll do it on air.
Damn.
Oh,
okay.
Shit.
Boom.
All right.
I'm gonna let all the girls roast you, bro.
Oh, okay.
There you go.
Fair enough. And we just hit 6,200 live viewers, guys.
Oh,
thank you so much.
Like the video.
Iceman.
Sub to the channel, fellas.
$50. Let's have a moment of truth, ladies. What advice do you have for 18?
Ooh.
And for JB.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. They
want not so
bring it in. I need it. Come on.
Okay. Hold on. Before we get into that, let's finish off with the questionnaire that we had for the ladies. So you've asked yours. Go ahead. Your go.
Okay, what do you guys rate yourselves and why?
1 out of 10?
Yeah.
Mm.
Okay, not bad.
Good one. Mm-hmm.
You know, me first?
Oh, you know what?
You know, come Let's on, go. Man. We know where I'm going with it. Shit, that's an easy number.
You go
yeah,
first?
Go ahead.
I mean, I'm one of them ones. You know what I'm saying? So I'm just that. I can't even put it in a category number-wise. It's just... My statistical facts of the human I am is just immortal. Like, you know what I'm saying? I could break it all the way down scientifically. People, like I told in the podcast before, I'm not cocky, I ain't confident. I just go off pure facts of life. All right? Mm-hmm. Let's break it all the way down again. I'm 6'6", right?
Yep.
I'm 230 pounds. Okay? That means I'm in great shape. I'm a millionaire. You know what I mean? I'm very smart.
Already in the 1% just off that alone.
Yeah. Just off that alone.
The point, actually, more than the one.
So
it's lower than
you, 1%. When you're 6'6", you're already 98 percentile of the entire earth of men. I'm taller than 98% of men off the rip. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So that's already crazy. And some tall niggas, they ain't in shape. They ain't. Nigga, I take my shirt off. I'm looking like, ain't too many you can compare it to.
Diesel.
I mean, it's crazy. I surprise myself sometimes. I'd be like, damn, that's me. So not only am I tall, I'm in great shape, right? On top of that, very intelligent, you know what I'm saying? Rich, you know what I mean? That's a blessing. All praise the Most High, first and foremost. Very, you know what I'm saying, hilarious. You know what I'm saying? Hello, why the chick cross the road? Like, shit like that. So it's like, you got to have all those elements. Then on top of that, don't have no kids.
Yeah, facts.
Never drunk liquor in my life.
Yep.
Never smoked weed. Never did a single drug in my life. Find another nigga.
Facts.
It's impossible.
Facts.
My attributes is impossible to find no other nigga that's walking this earth. And still break a nigga jaw in the blink of an eye if I got to. It just ain't one. You know what I mean? So I'm immortal. Fucking number. I'm just immortal. Three of them to God.
Okay. Someone switched out to $200 for the IG roast?
Yeah,
okay.
Get the right quick.
Oh, he wasn't playing.
Yeah, he wasn't playing. He really
Holy
wants
shit.
Oh,
he want that
Damn.
Shit, really.
Okay, he really wants his IG to get
roasted.
Okay,
we got to do it.
Get his ass right.
All right. We got you, bro. We about to cook you right now. Well, we
tell us your honest opinion about this guy's Instagram.
Y'all got to zoom in. Make that shit bigger.
Yeah,
I have to say something.
Let him see.
All right, we're gonna zoom it in right now.
What?
Who said that? That was her?
Yes.
Okay, go ahead.
It was me. I'm going to say that he looks funny.
Oh, that guy. Oh, shit.
Hold on. That was like the funniest thing ever. It's funny. It's
hold on,
simple, but good.
You look like you just got caught
bruh.
Masturbating by your mom.
Bruh.
Bitch, why you got your grandma's fucking oven mitt in the background of one picture? Like, the fuck? Hold on, no, scroll back up, scroll back up. What's that picture right there where the fucking he's in the kitchen? What you doing, fool? You look like you just jerked off.
Exactly. He's got caught.
You look like you stealing your niece's Christmas presents.
Oh, is he a troll?
All right, so what we're going to do is we're going to go from here around. Ladies, just give us a quick quick little thing, your view on his Instagram. We'll
and then,
start with
and then one thing I want to say, would you ever go on a date with him?
There you go.
No.
That's good.
Come on.
All right, go ahead. We'll start with you first. Go ahead.
If he's rich, though.
Yeah.
Oh, well. How much we talking?
We talking about 10 mil.
10 million?
That's a good number.
I can fix this nigga up.
Hell yeah, I bet you can.
I have him swagged out.
All right, so, okay, so what's your take? So, no?
Oh, God.
What?
Please,
leave. Okay, no. It's a no. Just all right, no. Cool. Yeah, and his profile, all right, terrible. Okay, what about you?
No.
Hell no? Okay, fair enough.
If he wanted to play the part of my gay best friend, for sure.
Okay.
That's the only way.
Okay, fair enough.
I feel like he just paid for a custom. Like, he's literally jerking off to our voices, talking shit about his Instagram right now. I'm be real.
Okay. Damn. So, Kiki, would you give him a chance? Would you take worse. Let him go on a date with you?
Bitch, you better put a deposit in.
Okay, what about you, Miss LA?
You got some money.
Yeah, for real.
Hey, lovey, I think you should make a new Instagram profile, because if I were to see you on Instagram, I would block you.
Damn.
It's he looks like one of the guys that requests me to make fun of their small penises.
Oh
my God, you have such a little dick.
Oh, shit.
What can I do with that?
I want to know what your dick looked like. Actually, send me a dick picture on my Twitter, @ClautKiki. I want to see.
Oh, shit.
I'm curious.
He's okay. Curiosity.
Curiosity spooked the cat.
Look at my pinky and...
Oh, shit.
There you go.
Okay.
You don't even need a picture. Just look at my pinky.
Damn.
Okay. What about you, Mexico? You said he's funny.
Can I see his profile picture?
His profile picture?
It's a clown.
It's the only that.
At the very top of the front.
The profile picture is the only that I see when someone is following me.
Smart. That's smart.
So. Yeah.
That's there you go. Merry Christmas.
Maybe.
From his dick, he took
I lost her request or her follow in my followers.
Wait, hold on. He has stories.
For his.
Yo, watch his stories. Pictures.
Wait, what did it say? Only hope.
Can only hope it works.
What's working?
Somebody said. All
right. Okay.
All right, my friend.
There you go.
You need to go ahead and buy DMs on demand.
Yeah,
that was awful. Yeah, that was awful.
His IG info box said, club entertainer.
Hold on.
God damn.
Hey, man. You heard it right there, bro. The ladies roasted you. I was going to put the chef hat on, but I ain't even going to do it.
R.I.P.
R.I.P.
Okay. Question.
R.I.P.
Yeah. So,
Organik.
Organik. Did you finish?
Oh, what was I saying? What were
you talking about yourself?
No, you're immortal.
Rating 1 to 10.
Yeah. Immortal. Yeah. Come on, man.
No ratings.
Yeah, no, I don't want 1 billion, man.
One of them once.
Yeah, yeah. But everybody should feel that way about themselves. Like, true indeed, like, self-confidence is very important in this world. A lot of people ain't got, you know, self-happiness, and mental health is very important. So I lived my whole life with a high self-esteem, and it really got to me where I'm at today. So I talk this shit, and I really mean it, but I think a lot more people should think highly of themselves and work hard and truly impress their self. You know what I mean? It's very important.
That's being able to look at the man in the mirror and be happy with what you see is very important.
What you see is what you get with me. This ain't no game. Anybody knows me know I always been like this. So it's not because I got money now. I've been the same nigga when I was nothing. So I just feel like everybody should tap into that. You know what I'm saying? Love yourself for real, for real. Like, all jokes aside, you know what I'm saying? Mental health is important. Love your fucking self, man.
Yeah. Fair enough, man. Fair enough.
What'd you rate yourself?
Are we going to rock, paper, scissors this joint?
Yeah.
Yes! Oh, damn. So I got to go first. So here's the thing. I would say, because there's always room for improvement, right? So you can't say you're perfect. Mm-hmm. So I'm going to give myself an 8.5, 9-ish, you know? Once I make my first meal, then I'll put myself a 10 out of 10.
Oh, yeah, you get that meal.
Yeah. So, yeah, that's what I would say. If I'm going to go off raw numbers of, you know, height, being in shape, all this other stuff, because that's the world we live in as a man.
Yes.
As a man, you have to bring tangible traits to the table. I hate to say it, ladies, but you guys get the benefit of being able to be ambiguous. I'm sweet and feminine and nurturing and cute, which, no offense to you guys, you know, these are all amazing qualities, but the beauty is that you can be ambiguous with it. As a man, how tall are you? Mm-hmm. How much do you earn per year? Mm-hmm. Are you confident or not? It's very You know what I'm saying? A guy that's confident versus a guy that isn't confident, it's very obvious. You know what I'm saying? But with women, it's like you guys are afforded a little bit more wiggle room in what you guys bring to the table because men aren't as selective as you guys are. You guys are far more selective than we are.
Way better.
So, yeah, cool. So that's what I'll say. Go ahead.
For me, I would say honestly right now, the 7. Just because I know I'm not in shape, I know I'm focused on certain things, and like I got things to like improve on. So I'd say 7 out of 10.
There you go. That's good, man. That's good. Cool. Always room for improvement.
Good confidence, bro.
Yeah.
Organik.
Yeah.
Question. You know what?
Well, so the ladies got to ask us.
Remember? We'll do him next. Yeah, okay, cool. Yeah. Kiki. Yeah.
Give me next.
Bro. Okay. Question for us. This is a question for Fit and Fresh. I'm sorry, I have two, but this one's quick.
Uh-oh.
Oh, shit. She's going to put us on the spot.
So, wait, no. I'm curious. Uh-oh. What happened to Don DeMarco?
No, we still have it.
We still got it.
I played it earlier.
Did you?
Yeah.
Why didn't I hear it?
Come on, man.
Chris, play.
No, we played it like 3 times already.
Oh, yeah, from the battle rap shit.
Yeah.
No, refresh my ears one more time.
Again?
Okay.
Yeah,
okay, I was about to say, what the fuck happened? Okay, anyways, all right. Question for all three of y'all.
Yeah, sure.
If you were to meet a female for the first time, strapped or not strapped?
Oh, shit.
You talking about raw pussy?
Oh,
you
oh.
fucking raw? Or are you going to wear a condom?
Oh, okay.
Well, we all know what Freshwood likes.
What the fuck, nigga? Nigga, shut the fuck up.
Oh
man.
Okay, who's going first here?
Man, my name is Mr. Organik, man. I live an organik lifestyle. Protection is with prayers, man.
That doesn't necessarily mean though, because there are organik condoms.
That's true though. Man, I'm raw on that pussy, man. Like you're talking about, let's keep it organik. Like, we'll be playing around for like, you know what I'm saying? Goddamn, we're gonna initially try going that way. They be like, hey, no, I'm gonna put it on, goddamn, but I ain't gonna, hey, fuck it. You know what I'm saying? I made it this far, though. I don't know how I did, but God love me. You know what I'm saying? Shit, I don't know how I did this motherfucker.
Oh, shit.
Woo, thank you, God. Shit.
I would say, wait, on the first time?
Yeah.
It depends on the girl, bro.
How y'all struggle with this.
Nah,
it depends on the girl. Like, there's certain things that you gotta like, you know, look for or smell for. You know what I'm saying? Whatever. So I hate to say it like that, but yeah, you know. So
I'm about to cap, nigga.
You about to cap? You're gonna lie?
Okay. Please put the cap on backwards too. Put that motherfucker on like T.
Yeah,
up and
I already know
high.
What
yeah,
he's about
go.
To say. Yeah.
All right. Oh, fuck it. It fell off. No, because like, I don't want to see it on camera.
I know you're scared, brother. Shit. Don't be scared.
No, okay.
Let's be true.
I think the people already know.
The truth is, man. Your boy been burned a couple times. But thank, but thank God I'm good to go now.
Right.
But,
oh, my God.
Little pill or some days.
Yo, I will know. Run on calm all day, nigga.
And there you go.
That's the truth, man.
There's the answer. Okay.
Dang, I thought he was cute too. Not now.
Oh, shit.
Damn.
Wait, did you just say it burned you a few times?
I was kind of like, oh, he's cute.
I'm saying, like, okay, yo, most players, right, that have been in the game, like, you've been burned a couple times. Now, thank God, if nothing serious, it goes away.
Yeah,
but some people, that shit ain't going away. God
damn.
Yeah, facts.
But see, right. You get tested every 2 months or a month.
Especially you got certain life insurances.
Shit,
they test you all
you
the time.
You get tested every month. That's not normal. Usually you get tested every year.
Oh, I hope you get every test.
Nah, nigga.
Nah.
I need to know every month.
Honestly, like, even though me being a sex worker, I don't give a fuck if you a regular. Honestly, when I first got into porn, my agent told me 90% of the girls who come in the industry pop immediately because they've never been tested before. Like, it is very important to get tested if you're sexually active. I don't give a fuck if you're strapped or not.
That's a fact.
That shit, you can catch it with a condom or not.
Oh, you can catch it with a condom?
Real shit. Real shit. Real shit. Perfect. Yes, ma'am. You are just by wearing a rubber, you're just simply lowering your wrist, but that still does not take away.
So you lost points for you could do it once a year. You lost points.
Everybody get tested.
I just took all my tests. I am totally clean.
That's a blessing.
Oh, look, let's exchange papers and let's go from there.
I could totally exchange papers with you. I'm not so sure.
I can do it right now.
Yes,
I put it on right now.
Hey, you're fucking paper bags.
I can put it out right now. Like, God damn.
All right. Go ahead. You got a question for the gentleman?
Okay, gentlemen. Maybe most disliked thing you can find when you meet a woman.
Like, what turns you off?
That's actually a good question.
What's the biggest turn off you can, like, you see? Yeah. Or, like, you know. That's you know question. What I mean. Y'all know what I mean.
I'm going to say if she's ratchet, ghetto, I'm masculine, I'm good. Like, if she's coming to me like, oh, yeah, I'm an alpha woman, I'm like, bruh.
Yeah.
Stay away from me. Yeah. Like, I'm good off of that.
Like Young Ma type shit?
That's some dyke shit. I mean, like, I turn
but if
to,
we
like,
take looks out of it, how about that? Like,
no, that's personality.
Yeah.
Like, oh, like, what's up, bro? Or like, yo, let's go over here, bro. I'm like, stop. Just stop. That's just too masculine for me. Like, I need feminine women that's going to be cool. We have a cool vibe. And it's like, okay, you know what? I can fuck with you. Mm-hmm. Too masculine? I'm like, nah, I'm chill.
I mean, for me, it's always like, if somebody has a negative or a contradictory like attitude, you know what I mean? Like everything you say got something negative. Something you say, they want to do the opposite. Like, God damn. Like, even if it starts that way and the conversation can shift, then that's cool. But if it's just back and forth, or, you know what I'm saying? That shit fuck up everything. You know what I mean? That shit is like, God damn, get the fuck away from me. You know what I mean? And I hate a motherfucker ask 100 goddamn questions and they don't really want the answers, like, for no reason. What is that? Oh, I like the hat. Where you get it from? What? God damn, baby, sit the fuck down. Like, what is you asking me? Like, you don't want to know these questions. So it's like, yeah, that energy, I hate that shit. That shit got to be right. Then it fucks up everything. I don't give a fuck how bad she is. It's only so much a nigga can finagle to get some pussy. Like, the attitude, you can't go too long without it. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
You can fight other things, but damn, they got that attitude and that contradictory, battle you ass energy. I can't deal with that one.
Facts.
Yeah.
Yeah. I'll keep it simple. A woman that understands that I'm the man, I'm the leader, and she's got to follow. Nothing works when a woman is in a leadership position, especially within the confinements of relationship. So, yeah, a girl that's cooperative and going to listen, you know, my biggest thing, like, I've had chicks that are bad. Like, I'll be like, all right, meet me at this spot. And then she'll say some dumb shit. Like, oh, no, I want to go to this spot. I just won't.
It's over. I'm not going.
I'll just leave her on scene. I won't even talk to her no more. Cause
it's done.
The fact that you even have the audacity to try to, like, tell me what to do, it's already off rip. I'm not going to mess with you. Because here's the thing. She's going to suggest something else and still expect you to pay. So what I've started to do now is I'd be like, all right, well, are you paying? And they'll be like, no. And I'll be like, all right, then we're going here.
Right.
And then they show up there. Because then, I'm just checking them on their BS. Because, like, they'll try that, right? They'll see how far they can get along.
Yeah.
Because a lot of guys will be like, oh, meet me here. They'll be like, oh, no, I want to do this instead. And that guy will be like, okay, baby girl, go there.
It's over.
And that's wild disrespect because she's telling you off the rip on the onset that she can, you know, dictate how terms are met. And
that's masculine energy,
how it works.
Bro.
Yeah. So, you know, that's my biggest thing as a cooperative woman because I understand that I need to be the leader for her own protection. Because if she's the leader, I already know she's going to lead us to the end of the relationship. So you almost got to protect the woman from herself.
Facts.
And that sounds fucked up. But, hey, man, like, you look at any major religion, you look at any of the old texts, they even said it. Man's got to be in a leadership position every single time, man. It never works when a woman's in a leadership position. I get it, all you ladies. Some of you ladies here are entrepreneurs and make your own money. But I'll tell you right now, the more money you make, more successful you are, the smaller options you have with men because you guys can't submit and follow a man that makes less than you. That's why it's so important. All you guys mentioned a guy pretty much in the top 10%. So I understand that the reason why women say, I want a guy that makes this much money, a guy that's taller than me. I know the hardwiring behind it is women are looking for a leader. They'll say, I'm attracted to this. No, instinctually, you want a leader. That's what it is. So I just know that I have to be the leader. And if a girl gives me some BS about, I don't want to do this, or she's not cooperative, or she gives me a headache, I already know it's not going to work. So I don't fuck with her.
Bam.
Makes sense.
Cool.
Nice.
Thank you. You have what you got?
Okay, so have you guys ever dated a woman and she made more than you did?
Honestly,
no.
No.
Hell yeah, I did all the time, boy. I was slanging dick. I was like a gigolo for a while.
Hold
on. I used to do that all the goddamn time.
Hold on, yeah. You're right, I did. In Barbados. So there's this whole thing where, like, a lot of tourists come to Barbados, right? Like, divorce, older women, whatever, or, like, girls that have, like, daddy money for vacation, right? Mm-hmm. So I was like that. Like, I literally go to the beach, chill to the beach, see a white girl, yo, what's good?
Oh, for sure.
Chop it up. She'll pay for everything. That's what I used to do. But now that I'm, like, here and making my own money, nah, I don't do that shit.
Yeah, I should survive on
you gotta survive.
Yeah, when I was just trying to find my way, I was surviving on that motherfucker.
So is it intimidating for guys? Is that why you wouldn't date a woman that made more money than you? Or does it just not happen?
For me, it's not intimidation. It's more like I like to be in a frame of, you know what? If I'm the one that's going to be paying the bills and stuff like that, I want to have like a kind of like dynamic where she knows her role, I know my role. I feel like most women that make a lot of money or make their own money, they're very independent and they want to be equal. Mm-hmm. And let's keep it a stack. Like, men and women are different. So if we're equal, then we're not there's no balance here. So I just feel like if I'm going to be in that dynamic, like, I want to be the one that's making the shots, not doing it 50-50, because to me that shit don't work. But
it's rare. It's rare that you find a woman that has more money than you, that's going to treat you like the man you're supposed to be treated like.
Facts.
If they got more money, you, she going to treat you like a little boy. You know what I'm saying? Going to tell you what to do.
Not all the time.
That's what I'm saying. It's rare. Yeah, it's super rare. But if you find a one, I would, hell yeah, I did a girl got more money than me. Shit, come on. I love that. But as long as I'm still going to be the man I am, don't come treat me like I'm a little boy or something. But if she got more money than me, I'm still the nigga I am. Oh, praise the Most High. Let's get it. Shit. I'm with that. Rihanna, holla at me.
I'll say this, because a lot of women have this, this misconception that if I make more than the guy's intimidated. It's not that the guy's intimidated. It's that the guy, like I told you guys before, men operate in a fact-based reality, whereas women don't really operate in it. You guys operate in a feelings reality. You know what I'm saying? So men know deep down, if your girl makes more money than you, that time clock starts. And that time clock starts where it's going to get to a point where eventually she's going to lose attraction for you. If you don't get your shit together, I bet you all these women at the table, if I asked you, what do you like in a guy? Women always say ambition. That's translation for financial potential. Mm-hmm. And the thing is that, you know, and I'm sure all of you guys have maybe dated a guy before where you were the financial leader and you were paying the bills, whatever. It ain't going to last. Any girl that like pays bills for a significant amount of time for a man almost always inevitably leaves him. Why? Because women aren't built to provide for men. Men are built to provide for women, though. So guys know that if a girl is in a leadership position, especially financially, the clock starts. Mm-hmm. And that's why so many of them are uncomfortable, because they know at that point it's either sink or swim, you know, because the girl's going to leave them at some point. So, because the thing is that society tells women, get the bag, be successful, get money, whatever it is. What society doesn't tell you is that as you make more money, you're going to become, how do I say this? Majority of men are now going to become invisible to you. As men make more money, doors open. As women make more money, doors close. Mm-hmm. So, that's the uncomfortable reality of becoming a successful woman. I ain't saying don't become an entrepreneur and don't make money. I'm just telling you the negative side that society's never going to tell you that comes with that success as a woman. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? So I'll say this. I know that if I deal with a chick, like, and obviously it's got to be significant. So like if I make 50 grand a year and my girl makes 150K a year, I already know off rip, probably ain't going to last long term. Yep. Unless I'm going to get a come up, whatever it is. Because that's a significant money difference. Now, if I make a million a year and she makes 1.1, 1.2, it don't matter, because we're pretty much living the same lifestyle at that point almost. So that's not that big a deal. But when it's significant, where the girl makes significantly more money than you, that's when issues are typically going to arise. And the stats show it, man. Divorces that are initiated by women are 80% of the time. And on top of that, it's financially related. And there's a bunch of data to show that if a woman makes more money than her partner, the chances of divorce increase significantly. So guys know this, because dudes, whether you guys want to believe it or not, men study how to get girls. There's no dating channels for chicks on how to get laid, but there's a bunch of dating channels out there for guys how to get laid. We're one of them. So
there you go.
Men struggle with this, and men have to learn. So the reason why guys are intimidated is because men operate in a fact-based reality when it comes to dating women and dealing women in general, because it's hard for us to get women. So as a hunter, what do you have to do? You got to study your prey. You got to learn, right? Women, you guys are prey. No offense. You guys don't got to worry about, I wonder what kind of meat the lion likes. You know what I'm saying? You guys don't worry about that shit. You guys just show up.
You show up.
And you guys pick the best guy that comes to you. That's what it is. So that's why guys typically don't want to deal with women that make more money. And the other side effects that come typically with women that make money. Women that make a lot of money tend to have masculine traits. Assertive, dominant, competitive. And there's nothing wrong with that. There's nothing wrong with that.
Nagging.
You know, nagging possibly, yeah. Because especially if she makes more money than you, she's going to be like, hey, get on your shit, get on your shit. So, you know, these traits are attractive in a man, but they're not necessarily attractive in a woman, if that makes sense. So that's the other side effects that come with, like, success, because you ain't going to make a lot of money being, you know, a sweet, submissive, feminine woman. It just doesn't work that way, because people are going to walk all over you. So to become successful, you got to be cutthroat. Mm-hmm. And these traits, even though fantastic in making money, mm-hmm. horrible for attracting a man and keeping him, more importantly. So that's what I would say, like, that intimidation thing. It's a misconception a lot of the time. It's just that guys know it ain't going to work.
It's a fact.
Cool. All right. Next question.
That's your turn.
So, like, I don't know, like, what's the, like, what did a woman do to you guys that just blew your fucking minds?
Who hurt you?
Oh, what? No, she is actually the opposite.
No.
This is ready though.
No hurt bitch energy over here. I wanna know about the good. I'm all about positivity. What did a woman do that just blew your mind, where you were like, oh my god? It could be sexual, it could be emotional, whatever. Like, what did she do?
Organik, you wanna go first?
I mean, the most legendary thing a woman ever did for me was just truly believe in me.
Aw.
That's all I ever asked for.
That's so sweet.
You know what I'm saying? If you know they truly believe in you and you can look in their eyes and like they give you that right there, that's all a real nigga need. Mm. You know what I'm saying? The rest is going to be taken care of. But a woman just got to, that's all a woman ever did for me, just believed in me. Mm. That's it.
Bam. Yep. I would just say add value. Like, for example, even business here, like some girls, like they'll come, we chill, whatever, just smash, and then that's it. But some girls, like, they actually say, hey, you know what? How can I help you with your business? Like, okay, you need phone calls made. You need you know, guest papers for people to sign. Like, that type of shit is, like, to me, is a mind-blowing because they're not just bringing, you know, the box, but also bringing value. So, to me, just adding value.
Right.
Yeah, I agree. You know, making your life easier. I think, you know, the thing that women need to know is that men are very simple, man. Very, very simple. Isn't that... It's really not hard to like keep a guy happy, but it's very hard to keep a woman happy. So yeah, just adding value to some degree, man. Like little things, like if I go to like, you know, the store or whatever, and I come back and the spot is clean, that will make me happy. Like you know, like
so
you know,
simple,
yeah, it's very easy stuff. Yeah, man,
very
man,
true.
Like you know, I could do the whole husband story, it's the wife analogy story, but I'll do that maybe later. But yeah, so that's what I'll say.
Oh, honey ball.
Oh man, TB with another $100 super chat.
Thanks, TB.
That one. Thank you so much, bro. I'll give you Don DeMarco.
Okay. TB 100 bucks says, shout out to the AV team and the mods in the chat. You all also doing the Lord's work too. RIP to Sump Town.
Yo, shout out to the mods, by the way. Mods are doing a great
you,
job.
Thank you, mods. Thank you. So, yeah. We got anything else? Okay. Caught up?
Yeah, no, we got some more.
Oh, okay. Okay. I'll read these real quick. And then, MrOrganik. We'll ask the ladies a question.
Yes.
Jessica X, $20. Like the stream. Thank you so much.
Thank
all
you.
The way from UK with the 20 British pounds. Marcus Infinity, $20. Got Kiki in a turtleneck and organik dressed like man in the yellow hat from Curious George next to Precious Assailant. Get the likes up, ninjas.
Hold on. Where the turtleneck at?
Yeah, she ain't got
hold
no
on.
Turtleneck. Show them that.
You must be blind. You need to expand your screen because this Fashion Nova fool.
Ooh, shit. Sponsorship.
Yo, how many likes we got on the video?
I like Curious George, dude with the yellow hat, too. He was a good man. He took care of the monkey.
I liked him.
Yeah, he was a player.
Yeah, so that was my shit.
He was a boss. He had a monkey. He had to be rich back then. He had a monkey shit.
Oh, my God. I have a fan
guys, like
in
the
here.
Goddamn video,
how
man.
2.5K likes.
What?
Guys, get us to 3,000.
We got 6,500 watching.
Yeah, come on, man. Guys, get us to at least 3,000 likes right now. James Daggett, $20. Can these ladies please admit they don't want a man who's faithful? They say they do, but that's not what they lust after. We don't trust what they say because we know they'll eventually give in to evolutionary biology.
I've been admitting that I don't give a fuck if he's faithful or not. Like, I'm going to be unfaithful too.
Mm. Damn.
Fair enough.
In my opinion, can the girl join?
Real shit.
Exactly.
I like pussy too.
Exactly.
Yeah, I don't be liking all that shit when a goddamn dude.
You don't want to.
Not my woman. I don't like that.
I'm saying you got a bitch, but your woman want to join with
that's
you.
That's what I'm,
and
saying,
a
that's
new
what I'm
bitch.
Saying, though. Nah, yeah. I don't want my woman got pussy all in the mouth and all that shit.
Really?
That's supposed to be in my mouth. You know what I'm saying?
Like, oh, you just greedy.
Yeah, I am.
Exactly.
I'm a man. Barbaric Genghis Khan. I need all the conquests. You can't have none of this, too. This is mine. How dare you want a piece of my pie?
Yeah, I want to lick her pussy, too.
I bet you would.
If a guy's a millionaire, he's not going to be faithful, and that's just hardcore facts. So
it
as a woman...
On. There's only one I know in the world. My dog, Slim. That's
oh.
it. That's the only person I ever can trust and believe is Slim. Talk no. out car if he's the only faithful millionaire nigga in the world.
Try to Slim in the back.
That's yeah, it. I will give that to nobody else. Only Slim.
I am under grace, $20. Pussy price has been plummeting. What happens when all women are all 10s without dreams, without drama in 10 years? What will these females do for a living?
Pussy price has been plummeting. Oh, I just went up, baby. Hello. These titties 10 racks. The fuck?
Neo Hikari, $20. If my Instagram got exposed by the ladies like that, shit. It's on site, LMAO. I'm going to turn into Gordon Ramsay tonight. Thank you. And then Stefan Gibby, 96. It was game over for me from the beginning, but for real, great show, guys. Thank you so much.
Okay, that we roasted.
Yeah, yeah. That was hilarious. Organik, you anything for the ladies?
Question for the ladies?
Question for the ladies. Let me think. Let me get it. Hold on, brother. Gotta go deep into the, you know, abyss. You know what I mean?
Don't be scared to go spicy, because we got some ladies here that may have some stories.
Damn sure do.
Damn. We know you do, girl. Shit. You say you for last. Shit.
Hey, guys, as organik is thinking about this, get the goddamn
likes
up, because I don't want to start
the
show,
get
the man.
Likes up.
Yo, I pull my titties out at 10,000 viewers.
There you go.
Oh, oh, shit.
Oh, wait, don't do that, Kiki.
Wait.
Got a stream canceled again.
10K, that's good.
Yeah. We on Twitch, though, man.
Three and what? 3K, guys, get us to 5,000 likes at least, man. What is that? Is that 80%?
That's a little over 80%. Can anyone get on the poll or no?
Wait, can I say something, you guys?
Yeah, sure.
If they get the likes up, I don't know if the girls are down, but I'm down to, like, I know you guys don't want me drinking, but I can be the first one. Like, you guys can pour, like, some alcohol in my mouth and we'll pass it around.
Oh, shit.
Oh, shit.
If they get the likes up.
Oh, damn. Okay, we got Miss Atlanta in the house. Okay.
Hey, guys, get the likes up.
Get the likes up.
And, you guys, and, you know you want to see us do it.
Okay, and 18, you going to get on the ball?
I could do a little spin.
Okay. Oh, wait, no, no, no.
Shit. Not yet.
We need likes up first.
We need to get the goddamn likes up.
Facts.
Guys, I'm going to play this annoying Who Wants to Be a Millionaire song. Oh,
fuck our shit.
My bad. I'm going to play this until we get to what?
4,000.
4,000?
500 likes.
Trey, you call it. Well, how much engagement do we need, YouTube master? You are the YouTube expert here. What do we need?
We need at least 5,500.
5,500 to hit the percentage? Okay.
And also,
there's 6,500 of you guys in here.
If you're on Twitch, you need to follow us as well.
Yep.
Get us up.
So let's start shamelessly plugging and selling things.
Yes.
Okay. So we'll start with Mr. Organik, and then we'll start with, and then Kiki's OnlyFans.
I'm with that, man. Hey,
yeah, start selling stuff.
Yeah, make sure you go to organiklifestyle.com and get all the merchandise, you know what I'm saying? You see this lovely, 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 lovely velvet outfit, man. I call it Sosa, man. Niggas love Scarface. I was a Sosa fan. I'm with the boss of bosses, man. One phone call, all that shit you did was done like that, nigga. So when I hung the phone up, was 100 niggas in your backyard. It's that Sosa outfit, man. You understand me? Yeah, on top of that, make sure you go to organiklifestyle.com, get my book, get my soap, get my sanitizer. You hear me? Yeah, get my mask. Yeah. Make sure you stream the music, Mr. Organik. You know what I mean? Yeah. All that good shit, man.
Bang, bang.
Kiki?
Huh?
Kiki. She's going crazy on that motherfucker. All
right, Kiki, go ahead.
Buy my OnlyFans at KloutKiki. Sorry if I was not supposed to say that. And then I have Twitter, Instagram. I have YouTube. You could buy customs from me. You could send me a Cash App because you just love me. It's $KIKIKLOUT. I don't know. I sell panties, socks,
damn,
bras,
damn,
freshly worn
pictures, freshly worn. I have
bath water.
I still have browser squirt scene outfits that are for sale.
Y'all better get that now, shit. For the motherfuckers get flying away.
Any other ladies here having OnlyFans they want to pitch and sell until we get 5,000 goddamn likes? Oh. We need 5,000 likes.
18.
Molly Creams.
18.
Wait.
Molly Creams.
Why is it Molly Creams? Do you cream?
Do you want to? You got to subscribe.
Oh, no. I don't want to know.
You got to subscribe.
I don't want to know.
Molly Creams.
Okay. Yeah, guys, we're at 3.5. Get us to 5,500. Anybody else selling anything?
Anybody has like an Instagram?
I do anal on my only.
Okay. Nice.
Wait.
Question for you.
Yeah.
Are you a Knight Rider?
But?
Are you a Knight Rider?
What does that mean?
Like, you like black guys?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, I mean, cool. Of course. Come on, bro.
BBC. Yeah.
David Hasselhoff.
I have never done, like, a porn scene with anal, so the only way to see me do anal is on my OnlyFans.
Okay. Oh, look at Key. Oh,
playing with that motherfucker.
Look at this. Oh, no. Switch the camera. Oh, shit. Not that one, Chris. Relay the goddamn video, guys.
Remix.
Get us some 5,500 likes. We're about to get kicked off.
What's your Instagram?
My Instagram is la.lisa.11. And we also have Rich Tolls.
Me
and
Susie.
Yeah. Okay. Do that song verse. Again. I want to hear a verse.
Yeah, do that verse.
Let's do it. I want to hear this shit, though, because we're about to have a rap battle. I got one, too.
And if you guys don't want to hear these ladies in their terrible rap, you better like the goddamn video.
Last song, our new Instagram. We're going to release music very soon, and we're also going to perform at a club here in Miami very soon. So if you follow us on Instagram, you'll see what club we're going to perform at.
The Instagram.
Like the video, or else you guys got to listen to them rap.
And hold
Let's
on.
Do it.
Hold on.
I
everyone
hear
here,
it.
Everyone here is coming to the party, right?
Not. Oh,
Saturday?
Yeah, I'm coming.
Saturday?
I'm coming. Yeah.
Party?
I'm coming.
What the fuck?
Am Thank I you, Kiki.
Okay, go ahead.
All right, rap. Go ahead.
Follow our Instagram, RichDollsXO. If you follow my Instagram and Lisa's too, we'll keep you guys updated. But we're going to release some music soon.
Yeah.
And we'll give you guys a little sample.
I want to hear. Yeah.
No, we want to hear some
Let's
now.
Let's have a rap battle.
I'm so down for a freestyle.
Go.
Let him meet this pussy with my period on.
Damn.
Let him fuck this pussy from the back.
Let him choke me on and slap that ass. Let him fuck me once he came back.
Get the likes up.
What the fuck?
Wait, hold on, hold on.
Get the likes up.
I got one for y'all.
Cry, baby.
Uh-oh,
I'm
there she go.
What the fuck?
Let's go.
If you guys don't like the video, we're going to continue this rap out. Like the goddamn video.
Pussy in the house, I'm a house cat. I don't fuck with house rats. I ain't got a Snapchat. He asking for his ring back. Bitch, I already pawned that. I'm a fucking cash that. Cow stacks, bank rest. Get stacks.
Okay.
There you go.
All right, you want to go, miss some feminine beauty, divine, feminine woman? Yeah, aren't you a rapper?
Yeah, okay. Yeah. Cry, baby, on a dick. I'm a ride and get low. Pussy so good, feel the same as my throat. Push it in my mouth till a bitch start to choke. Hot tie game, then I let him dry the boat. I'm a freak, bitch. Let him bust it on my ass, come and skeet, bitch. Let him fuck me in my ass, come and skeet, bitch. Did slit down my jaw like a ski trick. Yeah, freak. Bust it on my ass and rub it in. Money made me come with this and rubber bands. I can jack his dick with my money hand.
Something like that.
Did you guys censor
that? Like the goddamn video!
No!
Like the video!
Hurry up, please!
Help us! We will continue the music!
Help me! Help me! Please! Like!
We will continue the music until we get 4,000 goddamn likes!
Shit! Help me!
4,000 likes, guys!
My ear bleeding!
If y'all not fucking with that, y'all don't know music.
Okay. Hold on. What's your Instagram?
I got blood in my ears.
No, come on.
I'll give this buck with you, baby.
My Instagram is my name, a brill Elon.
Coming out
of my
eyes, too.
A brill Elon, A-B-R-I-L-E-L-O-N. Like I said, I'm a traveling celebrity hairstylist, so y'all can find me in all the local states and cities. Atlanta, Georgia, Los Angeles, California, Miami, Florida, New York, Houston, and D.C. Okay.
Get your head done. Get your head done.
What's your Instagram real quick, Team Skeet?
L-I-L-P-E-R-K-Z.
Boom.
And get on our OnlyFans to see Angel.
What's your Instagram?
Just taking that motherfucker in there.
It's Scotty with double K, like S-K-K-O-T-I-E.
Cool. And what's your Instagram?
My Instagram? It's molly.creams.
Okay.
Okay. And Susie, what's your Instagram?
It's SUSIEX_O. All right. Cool. Lovies.
Awesome.
Guys, like the goddamn video. What are we at? Are we at 4K yet?
Come on, you guys.
Yo,
like
you
that
guys
video.
Are some fucking ninja watchers, bro. There's like, we had like 6,500 live viewers. 3.8. And yo, get the fucking likes up, guys.
For real, man.
God damn, it ain't that hard, bro.
What's going on?
Let's just please click
the
goddamn
video. Why do I need
to
get on the table and play with my foot?
Seriously.
It's coming out. Write the video right now.
Write the video.
Right now.
Right fucking now, man.
Should I take off my sock?
Yeah.
No, can I suck your toes?
Yes.
No, 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 no. We need you alive.
Do it.
We need you alive.
Suck your toes. Suck the motherfucking toes, baby. Bring that foot over there.
No, no, no. I need her alive.
It's okay. It's okay, baby. We'll do it privately.
Yeah, there
okay.
You go. Everybody meant to see everything.
I'm letting it happen.
I'm having that.
On the only
I'm legit, my heart was beat. I was like, no!
Shit.
God damn. Yo, like the goddamn video, man.
Yeah, friend.
You're right.
Oh, shit, man. Like the goddamn video, you fucking ninja watchers, bro.
Like the video, man.
Sheesh. Trey had the goddamn...
Sheesh.
Sheesh.
So, anyway, where are we at now?
We're at 4.1K likes. That was fast, man.
We had fucking fist nut sack sweat.
Okay, going back to Mr. Organik.
Right.
You had a cue for the ladies, man?
Hey, I'm still trying to. I'm trying to get
okay, you know what? Intermission.
Yeah, help me out,
I need to see you on the poll.
There we go.
Oh, shit.
Oh,
okay.
Go.
On the poll. Okay.
We need some money guns.
We got the music going, too.
Money. Oh, yeah, I know. We both got to move. Hold on a second.
Oh, yeah, we got to move. Yeah. Move so she doesn't.
Since I have to move.
Sheesh.
Let's see what's up, Miss Creams.
Ooh.
It's slippery.
Hold grip.
Oh, this is about to be the worst dance. And I'm just kidding. You. Go ahead. Oh, okay. Somebody spin it around. Spin it. Okay. Okay. You gotta get up there high.
I'm mine.
Okay. Oh shit. Oh shit. Oh,
Merry Christmas!
for all you horny niggas,
have a St. Patrick's Day.
Happy Columbus Day.
Damn.
Don't go to the corridor.
Yo, what's going on right now?
I don't know what's going on, but
holy shit,
that was lit.
Okay,
you guys did a split. 18 did a split, man.
Yeah,
you guys missed
split.
That one, man.
Damn.
Guys, I was supposed to join. I can't hold it for that long, but
good job.
And I'm going home with her tonight.
Oh, really? That's exciting, baby.
Girl on girl action.
That's exciting.
Girl on girl action.
We live together.
Oh, same building.
Yeah.
Okay.
Same floor.
Right, I got a question for the ladies.
Yeah, he got it. I got something.
Damn. All right, tell us. I want to hear each of the ladies' craziest sex story.
Yes.
I'll start with Miss Dominicana to my left over here.
Oh my God.
Yeah, you got to talk into Mike though.
Yo. Quick question for you though, Miss Dominican.
Yeah.
You like red?
Huh?
You like red?
Do I like red?
Yeah.
It's my favorite color. Why?
I could tell.
Why?
Because. It's all your penis.
Oh my God.
It's all your penis, baby. Shit. No,
you put me in a spot.
Yeah, you know.
Okay, you got to talk into the mic, though. You got to talk into
it. It happens. Crazy sex story. So, like, I had sex. Well, not sex. I was in a Tesla. And, like, I ate a guy's ass.
Oh, no.
What the fuck?
And I liked
Toss
it.
Toss salad, baby.
And I liked it.
I fucking liked it. I like my salad, baby.
I thought it was, like, the best exchange of sexual energy. Because I'm the woman. And I'm used to getting catered to.
Right.
And I was like, yo, to hear him like moan and like.
You
I was
were tonguing
like,
that motherfucker.
Ain't nothing wrong.
Did you have his legs like above his head, like a goddamn Boston crab? No. Yeah, I like a bitch Boston crab.
No, that would have been kind of like that. That would have been a lot, though.
Ain't nothing wrong with it. You got to go there, though. Yeah.
Oh, damn. You know by experience, huh?
Oh, hell yeah. I mean, I grab my leg like that. Go ahead, baby. Go crazy.
Like a pretzel.
Ain't nothing wrong with it.
I pretzel up your bitch. Yeah, three of them.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm on that type of time. Just don't be putting your fingers and nothing that. Don't.
Why not?
Oh, yeah. I tried to. He's a smart nigga.
He grabbed
my wrist.
Yeah, don't go that far. Wait. Goddamn, now you're going
okay,
to.
I got to know. After you did that, did you kiss him?
Oh, no. But, you know, like, after when I went home, like, I gargled with some mouthwash and stuff like that.
Listerine.
But he was very clean, though. Like, he's very clean.
Was he hairy?
No. Well...
Nope.
Nasty. Just as a guy, Harry, but not like.
Wait, so did he ask you or you wanted to do it on him?
You know, he did the little scoot.
You just got to scoot, got to put your head a little bit lower. They already be on that Gucci to scoot up a little bit, put the little head. It's a little move. Yeah, it's a little nasty nigga move.
Oh, shit.
Don't do that. Don't act like you don't like it.
I never did that shit.
You never did it?
Never.
For real?
I mean, girls ask me. I'm like, nah, bro.
Why? You must have been burned like.
You still a virgin?
No, but shit comes out of there. Like, what the fuck?
No, you gotta be very clean, though.
Yeah, you gotta be clean, brother.
You don't want fresh zone.
Bro, when I... Nigga,
if it smelled like, I wouldn't do it. Like,
nigga, when I fart, you gotta die. So you don't...
I fresh.
Did he douche his ass before?
I don't know.
Because I know that some guys do that.
To be honest with you, I don't know, but he was extremely clean. Like, if he wasn't, I wouldn't
do it. So he did it.
Did you get a hair in your mouth?
I ate ass plenty of times. I never had hair in my mouth.
Women like to do that to a nigga.
I had hair in my mouth sucking dick.
It's an exchange of feminine masculine energy. It's actually kind of cool, though.
Yeah.
Like, I don't know.
All right.
Okay.
Cool. All right.
I know for a fact I don't have a story worth telling. Especially at the hearing.
You have a story, you just thought
I'd bounce off that one. And she was
she
in the car.
She took the cake for that.
It doesn't have to be spicy, but like, well, come on, give us something. Come on.
God damn.
For the craziest place.
A craziest place.
How many viewers on Twitch? Guys, real talk. Thank you so much.
Yeah.
We're on Twitch as well.
Listen.
Follow us on Twitch. We're almost monetized as well, so thank you guys.
I'm sure we'll be banned on Twitch soon. So.
Yeah, we will be. Thanks to Kiki.
Sorry.
But okay, Miss Hairdresser, come on. I'm gonna keep pressing you. Come on. Tell us.
Something.
Because we know you ain't the good girl that you try to say. Yeah.
No, I'm just like trying to think.
Stop the cap.
Stop the cap.
We know you know a story right now. Come on, man. You got one in your head. You're just like, I don't know if I want to put this on YouTube. It's okay. You can edit it a bit.
I just don't have a story.
Okay.
All
right. Right. Yeah, you got prices. Right. There you go.
All right. I know you got son. David Hasselhoff. You like the Knight Rider?
All right, y'all. This is a real story.
Oh, shit. Here we go.
Shit.
So, all right. High school shit, right? Dating a guy, 6 months, you know, losing my virginity type shit, right? Craziest story. My family went on a vacation to, like, this camping, whatever, retreat. We were all in an RV, and my mom, stepdad, my two sisters, my stepbrother, my stepsister, all were in the RV when I lost my virginity. They were all in there.
What?
And that happened.
Same room?
Did they see it?
Was that your uncle?
They were sleeping.
Oh, so no one...
No, so apparently, like, it was, like, I don't know, it was a family friend... a family thing.
Sneaky
so
uncle.
Everyone got to bring their like friends or boyfriends or whatever, and they like were supposed to be sleeping on cots, and I lost my virginity with my family there, you know? I felt very supported.
Oh shit. Wow.
I did. I felt their support.
That's okay. A blessing.
I love
blessing.
That though. I lost my virginity in front of my friends.
Right?
But not my family,
I'm
my
like,
friends.
Mom, I'm doing it.
Oh,
so
shit.
Damn thing.
You'd be so proud of me.
All right. Fair enough. Okay. So
Kiki.
Yeah, Kiki, what's your craziest sex story?
I got quite a few stories. What you want to know how I got pink eye from cum?
No.
How? All
right. Let's do two stories because we got to make up for Miss Hairdresser being whack. So, celebrity hairdresser, aka celebrity, not tell a story.
Man.
Girl,
oh, man.
Yeah.
Oh, man. Let's go. Let's hear it.
All right. So, I'll tell my story how I got pink eye in my eye. Okay. So I was supposed to, so I flew out to Vegas, I did my shoot, everything was great, and then like the cum shot was happening, he came on my face and I felt it like on my forehead, but like I was getting ready to get in the shower to wash off after the scene, the shit dripped in my eye and I felt that shit fucking burning. I was like, yo, what the fuck is wrong with my fucking eye?
Yeah.
It's turning pink, it's red as shit, I have to fly out back to LA. So anyways, like I knew something was up. So anyways, I get back to LA, the next day I wake up, I'm like, yo, there's something wrong. Like I got motherfucking pink. I had to cancel shoots because of it. I was pissed. I went to Kirill's house, the guy who has Assholes for Live Forever, that brand. I went to his house, so I wore a fucking eye patch.
I see the stories.
I wore a fucking eye patch during his story.
Wow.
Literally playing fucking anal ring toss with an eye patch on my face. Like,
God damn, Kiki.
Kiki, first mate clout.
Yo, it's funny too, because we stuck ping pong balls in our ass, and I tried to catch a ping pong ball out of Brooklyn Gray's asshole with my mouth. And then we put a dildo to a drone, and I like was sucking a dildo while the drone was like flying.
God bless America.
Whoa. God that was America. A lot.
My life is crazy. That's all I got to say.
That's why I couldn't let you suck yourself, because I need you alive.
It's on Twitter, though. It's on Twitter, you guys, and you can check it out. It's at Clout Kiki. Look through my media, because I got some crazy shit.
Man, that's hilarious.
Okay.
Susie?
Hey, lovies. Can I tell you my craziest story for a shot? I'm so sober.
Oh, God.
Oh, she wants a shot? Okay.
Yeah. So bad.
Trey, can you give her a shot, bro?
Bring a white claw.
No, say it first right now. Say it first.
You know what, Fresh? What do you want? Do you want to give her a shot?
I'm good.
She redeemed herself.
Give her a shot. Give her a shot.
She's redeemed herself.
Well, she got to go back
I
by
totally,
you.
Because he said so.
She
so.
Got to go back over there by you.
No, he doesn't want to go over there. He doesn't like it.
All right, Susie, tell sorry.
Remember what I said, you guys, that I think it would be so cool, like, if the girls are down to, like, share a shot. I think that's so hot and sexy.
Susie, tell a story, please.
Okay.
Oh, you're trying to share a shot?
Yeah, you know how they do it?
How they do it?
Well, can I take my shot? And then, so you put a shot in your mouth, and then we just pass it on.
There's one all the way around.
Oh. Together.
I think that's so sexy for the girls to do.
Yeah, they got
to
share the juices, bro.
Yeah.
Yeah, share the juices.
You don't think that's hot?
No, I mean,
COVID,
hey,
COVID.
No, go ahead.
I'm glad I'm underage.
Oh. She just doesn't want to do it, that's why.
All right, so okay. Tell a story.
So in the meantime.
Okay, so the nastiest thing that has happened was pretty much inspiration for our song, Let Him Eat This Pussy with My Period On.
Oh, my
Cherry
God.
Yes,
Cherry
happened.
Pie Chewer.
What the fuck? Yo.
I was like, okay, if you want to, you know.
That's okay, though.
Wait.
That's gross.
You're telling me that he didn't stop at the red light?
No. Let him eat this pussy with my period
Hold on. That's I can tell you right now, one of y'all ate pussy with their period on because I stuck sponges up my pussy and I was horny and I still let them go down. I'm going to be real. I don't give a fuck.
That ain't me because I ain't eating nothing.
Yeah, you don't know. How do you, you don't know. She take a little baby wipe. Yeah. Real bad man don't eat, boy.
Real bad man don't eat.
Let him eat this pussy with my period on. Let him eat this pussy from the back.
Let him choke me out. He came back.
Let him choke me on and slap that ass.
I can't watch this.
Do you guys want me to take the shot?
Yeah,
take more likes, and I'll take the shot.
No, we're good.
Just
on
do
likes.
It now.
You're good on likes.
Just do it.
Yeah, we're good on likes.
Just do it.
Right,
or she's gonna rap again. You already know what my opinion for that.
You guys want me to rap or not?
No.
I need this pussy with my beard on.
If you rap, you lose viewers.
Oh my god. All right,
next. All right, next.
Come on, you guys.
Okay, next. 18. And tell the story when you were 18, not when you were younger.
Yeah,
not
yes.
Okay. So when I was 18 and not when I was younger. Okay, yeah, so I sure.
Please.
This was so please. Weird. People with their little role play kinks. I had a guy that wanted to pretend that I was his daughter.
Oh,
and
shit.
That was so nasty. Oh, after that, I felt like, I was like, yeah, you're a weird ass dude. I'm glad your kids don't live with you.
What? Kiki, isn't like that common though in the pee industry?
I was about to say,
it's common, but it was so weird for the first time that I had somebody wanted to hear that. I was like, ooh.
Was it privately in your private life?
Yeah, privately in my private life.
That's why. It's different when you get paid from a company and you have a script and you see that shit. I mean, don't get me wrong. I've been in the sex industry since I was 18. I've seen some weird shit. Before I was in porn, I had a guy flout to me every fucking weekend and wouldn't even touch him, beg me to fucking make him bark like a dog, sit in his cum, lick that shit up. I wouldn't even touch him. He'd pay me. Like,
yeah, I love that part.
Like, real shit. But it is weird when you aren't exposed to that shit. And she's freshly 18. Like, this girl was barely like able to do shit like this openly with like adults and shit. Like, yeah, she's a baby realistically. So she's exploring the world still, and of course it's gonna be weird and new to her. I mean, fuck, when we first found our dicks and clits, so of course we thought that shit was weird and we started fucking playing with them. We're like, oh, yeah, it feels good.
But even in the industry, it's step bro, step dad.
Yeah,
it's,
oh, step
it's not
yeah,
my weird. Real dad.
It's a high commodity. It's a high commodity.
Why you sure.
Mega detective. Nuh-uh, what you mean? Mega detective.
It's just like all these weird dudes, bro. That shit.
Okay,
yeah,
so.
But then it's going to be a nigga nerd type nigga. They don't count.
Weird.
So,
yeah.
Your story?
It's not crazy. For me, it's more like weird. Was in Canada, like 2 years ago, and the guy made me make pee after I come.
Oh. Piss on him.
Golden shower.
Yeah. Hot piss on his damn face. Yes. Piss on his goddamn ass.
Oh, that's
piss it by the motherfucker.
Holy smokes. Did he drink it?
I had to drink like
So you had to drink your own piss?
No.
Oh, okay.
He wanted her to drink.
Oh, him. Okay.
Yeah. On him. Yes.
Oh, you had to drink a lot of water.
Yes. Okay. Yes. I had to drink a lot of water.
And then you stood over top of him and pissed on him or?
I peed on a lot of guys.
I had one more thing to say. When I first started getting into all this OnlyFans and everything, I had a guy, he was going, I never went to go do it because I was scared or whatever.
How long have you had your OnlyFans?
Since I turned 18.
Okay, so like since your birthday, like I'm activating OnlyFans.
Okay, like a month after my birthday.
What made you get into it though?
I actually got a text. I got a DM. I got an offer. Oh, do you want to do this? You know, we can help you out. I was like, hell yeah, let's do it.
Okay. You have somebody who manages your OnlyFans?
I stopped.
Oh, okay, good.
Smart. Yeah. I had somebody that wanted to pay me $300 to shit on him.
Interesting. Okay.
That's funny, too, because my Adam22 interview, I don't know why he's been reposting it lately, but... anyways, we did an interview and one of my really good friends was like, I want a guy to shit on me or I want to shit on a guy type shit. And it went viral. And you know what? I gained shit fans from it. And I'm not going to knock his shit. Thank you.
Oh, my God.
Okay.
Boy, it's a weird world.
I'll send a picture of my toilet.
Okay. This was a great show.
Super chats. Yeah. Okay.
Holy smokes.
And then, okay, $20, Seth Dreyer, $20. If she makes more money than you and takes care of the finances, she goes into mommy mode. Very true.
Mm-hmm.
The relationship is done at that point. I've seen zero relationships last where the woman has to take care of everything. Absolutely. It doesn't work that way. ENG, $20. as someone who's always bagged girls, you got to be special for a 10% man to wife you up. WAP, degrees, businesses, all that BS isn't special and has little value to men. Dude inspires me. I'm going to be there at 25-ish, but Godspeed. Thank
the
you.
God.
Follow you, bro.
Yeah, he's talking come organic. On, we know it.
David Glamand, okay, or Glamond. If you guys invite traditional Middle Eastern women on the show, there would be no disagreements. LOL, thanks for the real content, guys.
Facts.
Hey, bro. Yeah, I'm Muslim, man, so I already know what time it is when you deal with, you know, women from the Middle East. Well, some of them, you know, definitely belong to the streets, you know, but...
She belongs to the streets. Uh-uh,
but other ones definitely know what time it is. Wayne, $20, super stickers.
Victory.
And then thank you very much. And then we got Omar and $50. As much as many may hate to admit, Myron is spot on with all his points. It's cold, hard truth people need to hear. Yeah, man, I'm very honest, you know, but they banned me off TikTok for saying it. Genghis Khan, $20. Girls on the panel, y'all want a guy that makes 100K a year. Realize you're sitting next to a guy that's wearing over $100,000. Black Genghis Khan. Also, where's the hat from?
The God, yeah. I mean, yeah, I am Black Genghis Khan. The hat from my guy, Keith and James. You get it at keithandjames.com, man. Shout out to my dog. He got a store in Rodeo Drive and also in Phipps in Atlanta.
There you go.
Shout out to my boy Shaq Live in the chat. Shaq Live, he's a very good photographer here in Miami. Shout out to him.
Okay, we got Black Wolf Inc. $20. Kiki, what are you doing? This is a fucking family show.
Not anymore.
Jessica X.
$20. Oh shit!
Get the likes up to make the rap stop. Thank you, Jessica. But our ears are already bleeding. Black Wolf Inc. $20. Thank you, ladies, for proving women can't rap for ish. If y'all can rap about sex and money, she belonged to the streets. Thank you very much. Our Raha. No, Rara Brown, sorry, $20. Can I like twice to make the rap stop? Big Bubba, $20. Yo, get these X-rated kindergarten bars out of here. Great value, Dominican. Nicki Minaj. Can salsa her black ass back to a job instead of rapping? You got a rebuttal to that?
What you gotta say?
My motherfucking black Dominican ass will be saucing right into your airwaves. So watch out. Rich Dolls coming to you very soon. Thank you.
Yes.
Okay.
All right. Justin Pearson, 20 hours. Come on, Fit. Let my man Fresh live. Foot blocking.
Yeah, man. Hey,
you was so close.
I was so close, bro.
Oh, I'm going to get it, champ.
Yeah, damn, man.
It was close, boy.
I was so close.
In league, I trust. I'm from Miami myself, and y'all boys are holding it down for the lost men out there, Maine. I'm in the Navy, and I support y'all boys. Get Stephas Cole on a podcast, please. Yeah, man. Thank you, bro. I appreciate it. TB, $20. Breaking Twitch TOS in under 60 seconds.
You guys
are laughing.
We broke our Twitch record today.
Yeah. Hey. No, he's talking about terms of service because Kiki was rubbing her
vagina.
It is what it is.
Bruh, so, I have a rebuttal for the what's
ahead.
It called? Where's it at? The little super chat y'all just got about women can't rap, or women rap about money and something. Okay, yes, I do belong to the streets. I will agree to that. But I rapped about Air Forces. I have a mix and master song that's talking about Air Forces.
You like
so
Air Forces?
I do like Air Forces.
Okay. I'm in good shoes.
I got an air.
Anything else, Kiki?
The end.
She said fuck you too, bro.
Okay.
All right. Anything else?
No, we good.
Okay.
So, last thoughts on the show, people.
Yeah. Okay, so we'll go around the table. Let's start with Ms. Dion.
Actually, one last question.
Oh, okay, sure. Go ahead.
Real quick. Spare or swallow.
Oh, shit.
Oh.
Huh? What?
Spare or swallow.
I know. Swallow.
Okay.
Spit.
You're a quitter?
Spit.
Yeah, she says spit.
Okay.
If you're my man, swallow for sure.
What if I'm not your man?
No, spit.
Damn. You can waste a seed.
Bye.
Right. Wait, do you spit on camera though?
Oh,
it's fake.
Damn!
So wait, you don't swallow on camera?
A lot of the scenes are fake.
Oh, yeah, okay. You guys didn't know that it's all fake.
It's fake.
Oh, for real?
Well, we don't.
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
We don't.
A lot of the time, it's.
So you tell me, it's mayonnaise?
It's, what is it called? What is it?
Cetaphil. But I'm not going to lie, I do swallow. I swallow in every single, hole I got.
Hey.
God,
oh,
yes.
Nice.
Legend.
All right, so, plan B. So you don't, unless it's your boyfriend.
You think you just keep it in your mouth? Yeah.
I just say what the men want to hear.
That's a fact.
Yeah, that's a fact, though. That's a fact. Susie?
Hey, loves. I remember this question from the last podcast.
Okay. Next.
No. But it's funny because at the time, I really thought you were telling me like, oh, I spit and swallow. I thought you were telling me that.
No, we're asking you.
No, I know. I know, but I just think it's funny.
like spit or swallow. Like I thought you were saying like, oh, I spit and swallow.
Okay, so which one do you do?
Okay,
man.
Stop it.
What do you think?
Oh,
you want me to tell you what I think?
What do you think?
I'm gonna be honest with you.
Honest with me. I think me and Fresh have like this like tension between us. Like we need to like just no, not like sexual, but yeah. I think me and Fresh have like this tension that we just need to like
release.
Go to the bathroom. Go ahead, take care of that.
Fresh,
go to the bathroom, Fresh.
I think we need to release it on the show and just you know like let's just like let it go. Out.
We can fart
hug
together.
Hug it out. No, yeah. Like, hug it out, like, yeah. Fresh, you know, like.
Look, we cool. I'm just saying, like, do you spit or do you swallow that? Okay, you but touch like, Fresh enough,
like,
by the way.
How you said, like, in the last show, you were saying that I spit and swallow.
Okay, so you did both. Okay, cool. Okay. All right, you did both. All right. There you go.
It depends on how it tastes. If it's in my mouth and it tastes bad, I'm spitting it out. If it tastes good, I'm going to swallow it because...
It's good for your body. It's good for you.
It's good for your skin too, guys. It clears your acne and everything. It's true.
Oh my God.
Get you right.
This is prime TV, motherfucker.
Yeah, we're more entertaining than anybody that came on TV.
Holy shit, that's awesome. Okay.
Spit and swallow.
I keep in my mouth and then I spit.
So spit.
No, it's not like salt. Spit.
Hey guys, but can I say something or no?
No.
No?
Okay, no. Go ahead.
Are we going to do the tequila pass around or not?
No.
Really wants to do it, guys.
Oh,
come
you guys
on.
No. That's so fun. I mean, that's... No?
Who wants to do it? Because I feel like...
I'm Mexican. No. I love tequila. No.
Come on.
Oh, she does tequila.
Do you realize what they're doing?
Let's pass it around. I think that's so hot. Yeah. Like, oh my God. I think that's so sexy. Like, oh my goodness.
I mean,
let's totally
she's
do
down.
It. I need come a 2 week.
Come on, lovey.
I need a 2 week STD papers before I.
Hold on. Hold on.
We can put the shot here and then I can drink.
No.
Maybe the guys will do it with us if the girls don't want to do it.
No.
Fresh.
Who wants to make out?
Okay.
Fresh and fit will do it.
All right. We're not doing it, all right? Because
YouTube.
Number one, it's YouTube, and then number two, it's our fucking show. You guys don't dictate how the show goes, so let me just make that very, very clear. I don't mean to be an asshole or anything, but like you guys, you ain't gonna tell us how to run our show. Period.
Aww. So YouTube will like block the channel if we do it.
Doesn't matter.
You know what?
It doesn't matter. No, you're missing a point. We're not doing it.
No, yeah. You guys don't want to do it, but what about us girls?
No.
Because he's controlling. He doesn't want to do it.
No, it's not controlling. It's that.
Stop.
Yo, listen, it's not about being controlling or whatever. Mm-hmm. It's that it's our show. You guys aren't going to tell us how to run our show, bro. Like, no.
You guys don't want
the
girls
to do it?
No.
Oh. No. All right, anyways, Myron and Fresh, last thoughts?
Last thoughts. I mean, we should let them.
This was a crazy show, man. Like,
we didn't get their last thoughts. They're supposed to give their last thoughts.
What do you mean?
Promote. Okay, let's see. Shirts. Good. Oh no. Party. Huh? Last thoughts on the show. Did you enjoy it? Did you hate it? Love it?
Yeah, I love the show. Like, guys, like this was awesome. And yeah.
Why are you so British?
What?
Why are you so British?
She's Dominican.
Oh my God. She's confused. Because I'm Dominican and black.
So she's confused.
They were making jokes earlier about her accent.
Well, don't. It's not nice, guys.
Okay.
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
Yeah. I like the honesty from the guys, especially Myron, for sure.
Okay.
I like how he just says the facts, because that's what it is.
Right.
And I love the confidence from Mr. Organik.
That
right? Like,
that's awesome.
Like, it's just, it's great. It's good to hear facts, and it's good to have somebody that's, you know, very confident. I like both.
That's awesome. Rare. Most people say Myron's a toxic misogynist, but thank you. I appreciate that.
Nah, she's smart. She understands the real world. That's all.
Boom.
I like it. It's real. It's cool.
Thank you.
It was fun.
All right. Appreciate it.
Kiki.
It's fun coming on here, watching you guys grow. Like I said the last time, like, it's just fun. We're all a big, happy fucking family.
Yeah, you've been here from the beginning.
I know.
So thank you for that.
It's been a minute.
Even though you've gotten, like, two of our streams kicked off or whatever. But
wait, what's the second one?
No, just one.
That's just one.
I was gonna say just one.
Well, no, this one's gonna get kicked off too.
Let's see.
Scary. No, but
it's fine, Kiki. We love you.
It's cool. Again.
Yeah,
any
sure.
other girl would have had an aneurysm, but.
Anyways, you guys go follow me on Twitter at Clout Kiki. That's the same as my OF and my Instagram, official Kiki Clout. I don't know. The show's great. I fucking love it. Can't get enough.
And we need an update from you on your life situation and what's been going on, because you obviously got your boobs done and everything else like that. So we need to bring you back for that.
I got my boobs. Yeah, exactly. We need to do like a whole Kiki Clout segment because I got a fuck ton of shit that just happened. So
we'll bring you on with Sterling.
I was out of the. Oh God. Yo, that video is going viral. I think it's got like 200,000 views already. On X videos, yeah, it's doing well.
And I didn't know.
I had somebody comment saying, "Who's here from the Fresh and Fit podcast?" And then like 18 likes. Like that was like, oh,
nice. That's crazy.
You know why? No, somebody DM'd me and said, "Hey, Fresh, look at Sterling and Kiki." I'm like, "What the fuck is this shit?" I'm like, "Nigga, X videos."
It's a porno.
Yeah. Yo, guys, please don't send me in Fresh. Your sex videos
care.
And stuff like that.
We don't care, bro.
Like we don't watch porn, guys, ourselves. Like we purposely don't watch porn.
We make our own porn, if anything.
We don't watch porn, guys, so please don't do that.
Susie, last thoughts on the show?
Okay, guys, so I want to get my boobs done, too. So I just started an OnlyFans. My OnlyFans is SUSIEX _O. Follow me, and I will post some sexy pictures. I really want to get my boobs done, because I think I will look sexy with my boobs done.
Yo, so, you funny, nigga.
No, like, for real. Like, I do want to get my boobs done. Like, I think I will look so sexy. Like, you know, like, I don't think, like, you guys did not ask us to, like, show our body.
Do you want to stand up then? Go ahead, stand up.
Yeah, sure.
Go ahead. Advertise that stuff. Yeah. Show the people. Show the people what they're working with.
Yes. Turn around.
Oh, it's just sexy. Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
So I'm getting back.
So I think my ass looks good. My boobs look okay.
All right.
Like,
all right. So
yes, Susie. Yes.
Those are last thoughts.
All right. So can you give us some last thoughts as well? last thoughts in this case.
Want to give you guys last
thoughts.
Speaking to the mic, please. Speaking to the mic.
Okay, guys. So follow my OnlyFans. I really want to get my boobs done. So
okay.
You said that four times now.
I know. Lovey love.
Okay. All right. Next.
Okay. Next.
Okay, so as for this is my first podcast ever, we popped the cherry today. I had fun. This was very interesting. I was a little bit nervous in the beginning. Mm-hmm. What made you nervous? I wasn't paying attention to the first question about the money thing.
Oh, okay. Oh, okay.
So I was like, oh, they said 100 grand? Yeah, 100 grand.
Okay.
But yeah, I had fun. This was really fun. Hope I could come over here again.
Awesome. Yeah, I mean, you kept it real, so that's awesome.
Yeah, you're
spread
cool.
The joy and the positive energy.
Spread the cream.
You're terrible on the pole, though. I will say that. Sure. No cap. You are terrible on the pole.
Okay. I don't have pole grip, and I'm wearing, like, come on.
Okay, next time, come up here.
Yeah, but still doesn't change the fact that you're trash on the
pole.
I'll
come a little bloody
next time. Yeah, you did put on a split, so that was cool.
The split was, yeah, I fucked with that one. That was hard.
I ain't gonna lie.
Legendary.
With the look back, too.
Okay, Catherine?
Can I? Yeah. Thank you. And I had fun. And I want my boobs too. So you can go and follow me on Instagram, Scotty with double K. Okay.
Just make sure you send your message in Spanish because her English is awful.
Wait.
No.
Go ahead in Espanol.
No, that's not right.
That's what's not right.
That's what you say.
All right. I'd appreciate if you stop tapping me, though, every time I say something. No. Like, seriously. No. Don't touch me either. Thank you.
But you're the one who has to take the STD test, though. Not
what?
Let me interrupt real quick.
That wasn't me.
Please subscribe to my OnlyFans, Molly Creams. You got to find out if she creams for real. Subscribe. It's free.
God damn.
All right.
And she's 18, guys.
And she's 18 free.
Young and pretty.
You guys, can I say something?
No.
Oh, my God.
No, it's up to them.
All right, go ahead.
Okay, one last thing.
Your mic is muted. It
better be good.
No, your mic is muted.
No. Like, yeah. I lived in LA.
Well, her mic is muted.
Yeah, it's muted. It's muted. She's done. She's done.
Trey, unmute it real quick. Unmute it, please. Go ahead.
I was going to say, like, you said you have, like, a Malibu estate. So let's throw a party, you know?
Oh, I don't do that. I'm private. Oh, you like, don't I'm, do that? I'm like Batman. You can everybody don't come to my house. Sorry. I ain't with all that party and shit.
Nah, you're not.
Yeah, I'm too. I'm a reclusive motherfucker in real life. You know what I'm saying? But
all right, shots down. Okay.
Damn it, because Ali is so lame right now.
Yeah, I like lame.
Hey, we know. I respect like live, her for shooting her shot.
Yeah, yeah.
She tried it, though.
East LA.
She shot the
East
shot.
East LA? Hell no. I'm not from East LA.
No,
oh,
not you.
East LA? I'm myself. He's from East LA?
Yeah. Okay, Molly, no, fresh, last thoughts.
That's East LA.
Hey, guys. Okay. Please stop having a conversation in the middle of a podcast.
Follow Myron, Unplugged Fit 2Ts. Follow me, Fresh Prince CEO. Follow Trey Talk Sports. Follow Chris, our producer at Aaron C. Pogson. Follow Mr. Organik. Yeah, and I'm gonna get the last word here, bro.
Hey man, I just appreciate everybody keeping it organic, like I like to say. Everybody took criticism and conversations. Even when me and her was going back a little bit, she stayed calm, I stayed calm. That's how I be sometimes, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Everything gotta be negative, everything gotta be disrespectful, you know what I mean? And be truthful with yourself and others. And once again, mental health is so important, man. Love yourself. You're looking at a person that never gave up on himself and became successful. All I did was believe in myself and work hard. Like I say, I do talk shit. I do like to make jokes. But in the day, it's very important to believe in yourself, love yourself. You know what I'm saying? Be positive. Get that energy back to people. And I just feel like everybody need that in their life, man, for real. There's something about that just changes your life. Make yourself happy. Like, we all could get money. We all could fuck and all that shit. Yeah. But are you happy?
Mm-hmm.
That's what it boils down to. All the money and all that shit. I know niggas with hundreds of millions hate themselves, hate their family, are you happy? You know what I'm saying? Like, get money, of course, take care of yourself, but God damn it, what are you risking to get the money? You know what I'm saying? Make sure you protect your happiness, man. Mental health is very important.
Wake Salute. Up and masturbate.
Word.
I ain't masturbated in 5 years, too, by the way. I think that was a key to my success. I swear to God, because I used to jack off all the goddamn time, right? I tell people this all the time. And I stopped jacking off 5 years ago, and that's when I became successful.
Wake up and get pussy.
It was like something that was like a habit. It wasn't even about the act. It was just something you addicted to, beat my dick. You know what I'm saying? I cut that shit off, and then I focused on other shit, and then boom, I was successful. I was the fucking bitch and then jack off after. So it was just something to do. You know, niggas, we just animals.
Yeah.
When I cut that off, though, I became way more successful. So I think everybody try to tap. All you niggas tapping into that.
Sacrifice.
I'm trying to tell you.
Once you have dick discipline, bro, yeah, no one can stop you, man. Yeah, because the thing is that girls can't finesse you no more.
Right. Bam.
Like when you could tell a girl, yo, shut up and like not care about her giving you box. That's very powerful because most women are able to dominate you with their sexuality.
Yeah. Yep.
But if you're able to like tell a chick like no and you don't care. Bro, no one can stop you.
Yep.
No one can stop you, bro. Every guy that like takes L's a lot of the time, it's always at the because of a woman, bro.
For sure.
So if you're able to exercise dick discipline, it's huge, yeah.
Facts. And I always do, like, even with me, like, even when, you know what I'm saying, I have a girl around or we at the crib or some shit, you know, you talk to a bitch all night try to get them panties off. You know what I'm saying? You touch the pussy, say, move your hand. You grab her ass, move your hand, move your hand. Now, like, the last 5-6 years, I touch her one time, they move my hand, we going to sleep.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. It ain't that serious.
You're
me,
nicer
baby.
Than me. I kick them out.
Yeah, but I can't because, you know, they goddamn make some shit up, brother. Come on,
okay,
Come on, brother Kobe Bryant.
I just turned my shit on. I gotta go sleep.
And they want to go home, then I'm going to drive them. Yeah. It ain't no Uber. I'm going to get in one of these Ferraris, Lambo. I'm going to take them in one of these motherfuckers. You don't feel good on the way home.
Fair enough.
I don't want no problem.
Yeah.
If I touch that ass, that pussy, you be like, no, boop, we going to sleep. Ain't no nothing. She got to roll over and grab the Excalibur, wake him up. But if you don't, I'm going to sleep, man. Dick discipline is very important, man. It's to give you salvation, give you freedom. You can sleep
Facts.
At night. Enjoy your success, niggas.
Facts.
Stop chasing pussy. Let the pussy chase you. Chase the bag.
There you go. Facts. There you go. And then they're going to come anyway.
For sure.
Facts. That's for Chris.
Your mic is muted. Trey's already muted your mic.
All right, cool. Okay. So,
great show. Right now.
Yeah, trade my meter to my
guys. Follow us on Twitch. Also, as well, party May 15th. This Saturday is going to be lit. Don't forget, follow us on Instagram. And great show, guys.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Hey, guys. We'll catch you guys on the next one.
Yeah.
Peace.